right now.
And go to the window.
Open it.
Stick your head out and yell.
Hated by the world.
The voice of Ocala with Buddy Martin.
You know I don't speak Spanish. In English, please.
Look in my eyes. What do you see? The cult of personality. The cult of personality.
Good Tuesday afternoon. Welcome to the Voice of Ocala on a chilly, albeit sunny, Tuesday afternoon. I say chilly, not really cold, but more mild than it has been recently. Nice sun, probably 73, 74 degrees. Now, if I could wake up every morning and it's 55 degrees and go to bed every night, you know, enjoy the day at 76, 77 degrees.
Life would be good.
That would be perfect. Or it'd be Los Angeles, one or the other.
Yep, probably.
Probably be Los Angeles.
Yeah. Which is still pretty.
Which is still nice.
Yeah.
Well, I don't know if you're aware of this, but the United States is Ebola-free. For now.
For now, yep.
For the first time in nearly 10 weeks, no Ebola patient is being treated for the deadly disease in the United States. America's all clear came Tuesday morning when Dr. Craig Spencer was declared virus-free and released from a New York City hospital. That shows you the difference between a third world country and a first world country. We're able to eradicate it, and only one person died, and that person that died was West African, who was so far gone by the time we diagnosed him with Ebola that he couldn't survive.
Mm-hmm.
That's why he's no longer with us. Everybody else, we diagnosed it early, got the treatment protocols in place, and nobody died. First time in 10 weeks, America is Ebola-free. Does that make you feel any better?
No. I was not.
Still a plane ride away.
Yep, that's true.
Still a plane ride away. It's Veterans Day today.
It is, yep.
Or Armistice Day, if you really want to be technically correct. Although it was changed from Armistice Day to Veterans Day, I believe, in the 50s.
1954, yep.
To include the veterans of World War II, Korea, and all wars that we had been in. It was originally Armistice Day because on the 11th hour of the 11th day of the 11th minute of the 11th hour of the 11th day of 1918, in the Great War, the war to end all wars, World War I, arms were set down. The treaty was not signed until much later, but until, I believe, March of the following year, April of the following year. But it's always remembered that at 11-11 on 11-11, I mean on 11, in the 11th day, the 11th month, the 11th hour, that arms were set down in World War I. Now it's turned into a day where we like to thank all of our veterans for giving us the ability to be free and talk on radio programs like we're doing right here.
Yeah.
So if you see a veteran today, you see somebody with a hat on says retired Navy or retired Marine Corps, tell them thanks. If you see a veteran, tell a veteran thanks for all he's done for us. You know, yesterday we didn't talk about, there was a birthday yesterday. We didn't talk about it.
Whose birthday? Tom's?
Nope. Buddy's? My birthday's in July.
Buddy's?
Nope.
Nope.
Little known fact, my father would always celebrate it by putting a flag out in the front yard on November 10th. He was a lifelong Marine. He would put the flag out in the front yard, the Marine Corps flag, because November 10th was the Marine Corps' birthday.
Yep.
Slipped right by us.
If it did.
But today's a very important day for veterans, and for America, period. I have a very good friend of mine whose father is a veteran of Vietnam, who is still very angry with the United States and how he was treated when he came back from Vietnam. And when you hear about the stories he tells and all, I'm not real sure I would have been pissed off too when I got back from Vietnam. You know, they threw blood on him, animal blood on him at the airport in Jacksonville when he got off the plane.
Why?
Called him baby killer. And threw blood on him. That's how protesters in the Vietnam War were welcoming back veterans who got drafted to go. I promise you, very few people said, yeah, hey, send me to the jungles of Vietnam. I want to go. But they're veterans just the same. Thank them for their service. When you run into a veteran, thank them for their service. We're working on the camera, Alex. We're on it, buddy.
I forgot. I'm sorry.
It's Johnny Walker's fault, Alex.
Yep, there we go. Can you see Tom?
There you go. Alex.
There you go.
Alex keeps us in line, buddy.
He does.
You don't mess with Alex.
Okay, there we go.
So it's Veterans Day. If you see a veteran or you know a veteran, tell them thanks for allowing you to be free in the greatest country on the face of the earth. Because say what you want. We can sit here and complain about Democrats and Republicans and what Washington's doing, what Washington's not doing. Oh, we're in a deficit. Oh, we're tanking. Oh, the Obamacare's killing us. Oh, the Tea Party's a bunch of right-wing wackos. We can all say all those mean-spirited things. But if we really were honest, you wouldn't want to be anywhere else. And if you are, if you're American and you want to be somewhere else, give up your citizenship and go. Because it's the greatest country. It's got its problems. All countries do, but it's still the greatest country on the face of the earth. That's why I don't understand these kids that get brainwashed through these computer online websites and all, and then think ISIS is the answer. Muslim kid, they had two more over the weekend, two more Muslim kids from Chicago. I read an article where Chicago's like this hotbed of Muslim extremists that want to go fight ISIS. Fight with ISIS. And I'm thinking, what? Okay, let's look at this. Go hang out in a hot desert with the threat of being bombed at any moment by American warplanes.
Yeah.
Or hang out in Chicago and live in America.
Stay in Chicago.
Yeah, I think I want to give up my American citizenship, go join ISIS and live in a desert and get blown up by American planes. That's just moronic. Don't make any sense to me. Makes absolutely no sense. Hey, coming up after the break, it's Tribunator Tuesday with Tom. Your chance to win. I got Mojos to give away. I got Marion County Theater tickets to give away. I got Bob Wine's gift certificate. I got golf. I think Joe just gave me something from Eaton's Beach. I got all kinds of stuff to give away. All that coming up next on Tribunator Tuesday with Tom. Plus, political correctness has gotten out of control, and I'm going to show you another reason why. It's down in West Palm. We'll talk about that next on 1370 AM, 96.3 FM. We're live and local on The Source.
Right on the southwestern corner of the square sits one of the finest dining establishments in Florida, Mark's Prime Steakhouse and Seafood Restaurant. Mark's offers big city dining amenities in a charming and small town setting. It's a rare treat to experience both the ambiance and the exquisite cuisine in a friendly atmosphere. Ocala's finest restaurant serves the finest beef, the freshest seafood, premium wines, and naturally fresh vegetables. From valet parking to splendid service, Mark's offers the complete package. Check it out today. Mark's Prime Seafood and Steakhouse Restaurant.
Let's give it up for old asphalt and a new pair of shoes. Let's give it up for a good rhythm meeting a sweet melody. For a church cookout under clear skies. let's give it up for good things coming together. Like bundling your auto and other policies together with an Allstate agent, which can save you time and keep you better protected. Let's give it up for good.
To receive your comparative insurance quote, contact the McDonald Agency at 622-2333.
Imagine yourself in a quaint bistro right in the heart of a charming French village about to indulge in real French cuisine. Located in beautiful, vibrant downtown Ocala, La Cuisine offers authentic French cuisine and wine from an award-winning menu. Patrice and Elodie moved to Ocala in 2009 because they fell in love with it. And you're going to fall in love with La Cuisine if you haven't already. La Cuisine offers a quick bite for lunch or a leisurely dinner in a comfortable and relaxed setting. So call La Cuisine of Ocala today at 352-433-2570. It's like a direct call to Paris.
Being the Culligan Man is not easy, because he works hard every day for you here in North Central Florida. Whether you need bottled water delivery for your office, a home water softener, or water infiltration system, the Culligan Man can help you. At Culligan North Florida, we have dozens of softener and filtration options, along with a host of media tank sizes. Depending on the exact hardness and usage of your water, we determine the size of softener you're going to need. And if you're on city or well water in one of our local areas, the in-home water analysis is absolutely free. If your needs are for the home, call Ocala Water Conditioning, 352-291-5900. For home or business bottled water in Ocala, call Ocala Bottled Water, 352-291-5900. Culligan of North Florida, a proud sponsor of Florida State Football, heard right here on WOCA, The Source.
Are you a mom looking for inspiration? Are you creative? Mamazine.com is a lifestyle blog designed for the local mom to be inspired by the beauty of motherhood while staying current on local events and issues. Visit Mamazine.com today to find events around town, recipes, imaginative play ideas, and more. Mamazine.com.
On the next AM Ocala Live, Robin and I will be speaking to Dr. William Reed. He's one of the first successful heart surgeons in America, and he's written a book. It's called The Pulse of Hope.
News Bites, the hottest news and current events are bite-sized.
And then Dr. Gloria J. Walther is coming on. She's got a book called Eye to Eye, the handbook on lovingly and successfully parenting your 3 to 5-year-old child.
Lori Arnold is a multifaceted vocalist. She performed for Pope Benedict. She'll be on the air with John Leshak, and they'll be speaking about her concert on November the 16th.
And then representatives from the education community in Ocala and Marion County will be speaking about the salute to veterans.
Have all of your legal questions answered by attorney John Fuller on Legally Yours.
And then Paul Smith will be on. His book is called Parenting with a Story.
Sharon Nice is the president and CEO of the National Waste and Recycling Association. What becomes of the trash we throw away?
All of that plus fun with Joe on the next AM Ocala Live right here on The Source, WOCA 96.3 FM.
1370 AM.
News Talk 1370. WOCA invites you to discover your full business potential. News Talk Radio is the perfect environment for your advertising. WOCA's News Talk format pinpoints information hungry, better educated, high income adults. So use us to talk to them. Call 732-8000. 732-8000. We're Ocala News Talk Radio. News Talk 1370. WOCA.
Welcome back to The Voice of Ocala. Trivia Tuesday with Tom. Let's give away 2 rounds of golf to Ocala Golf Club.
Okay? Sounds fun.
2 rounds of golf to Ocala Golf Club, a $65 value. Call us at 622-9622. Answer a trivia question in either science, history, or geography, and you'll be a winner. Let's go right out to the phone line. Oh, we don't have anybody on line one? All you got to do is call 622-9622, answer one question, and get 2 free rounds of golf, $70 value, $65 value.
That's it?
Yeah, that's it. That's all you get. Not a bag. 2 rounds of golf free.
Nope, not bad.
Yeah. Okay. Political correctness has gone a little too far. And I say this saying that, yes, I know there's certain words you can't use and you can't go and say certain things, but I'm a firm believer that you can say whatever you want to say. You just have to face the repercussions of what you say. Mm-hmm. If you want to be degrading towards women, be degrading towards women. And when a group of women corner you and beat you to death, that's on you for being degrading. If you want to aggravate Hispanics, aggravate Hispanics. But when a group of Hispanics take you to court for slandering them and take all your money, that's on you. Don't tell me what I can or can't say. That's just, I'm tired of the political correct police saying, oh, you can't say that. Well, how about I tell you to shut up and don't be political correct police? How about that? Well, that's what happened in Boca, in West Palm. Somebody's gotten crazy again. A department store put this sign up in their Santa, in their display, their Christmas display. It says, Dear Santa, this year please give me a big fat bank account and a slim body. Please don't make the mistake you made last year by getting those two wrong. That's funny. There's nothing wrong with that statement. There are mothers up in arms saying that statement tells little girls you got to have a big bank account and a slim body. You can't have a big body and a no bank account. That's not what it's saying. It's just being funny. I'm tired of people saying that there's all kind of, oh, look at the message you're giving to the, we're not giving a message to a little girl. We were being funny. Oh, we're gonna be okay. I don't like the message. Well, so don't listen to the message. Here's the thing. If you don't like what that Dillard's department store put in their sign, instead of going to the news and making a big story out of it and, oh, this sign's got to go, it's demeaning, how about just don't shop at Dillard's?
But I like Dillard's.
But you wouldn't think the sign's stupid.
No. I would just forget about it.
It's just a funny sign. We get a little carried away with our holier-than-thou, what we can and can't say, because somebody may get offended. Let me explain something to you. People have been getting offended for years, and we're okay. I'm tired. Oh, you can't say, you may. So now if I say, oh, I don't like green people, are the Martians going to come down and get offended? But am I going to have to apologize to them because Marvin Martian with his P-38 modulator got upset at me? Because I said I don't like green people? Is the Jolly Green Giant going to start, come on, ho, 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 I heard what you were saying about me. You don't like green people. Is David Banner going to get angry, the Incredible Hulk going to come smash me because I said I don't like green people? I'm so tired of political correctness. Let's go to a caller on line one before I lose my mind. Who do we have?
We have Dan.
Hey, Dan, how you doing?
I'm doing good. I'm impressed you know what Marvin the Martian uses to blow up planets.
He uses a P-38 modulator.
I'm impressed that you know that.
Dan, I'm 48, pal. I grew up on Looney Tunes. That's another thing. That's another thing. People say, oh, all this gun violence on TV. What? Elmer Fudd would blow Daffy Duck's beak backwards. Shoot him right in the face with a loaded 12-gauge. None of you and I, Dan, we're both about the same age. That didn't tell us, hey, you can go shoot somebody with a 12-gauge in the face.
Well, even I was watching a commercial from the 60s the other day. Mattel made a machine gun, Tommy machine gun.
Yes.
It sounded like it was shooting. I don't know. Kid, get your own machine gun.
Yeah, exactly.
That's nothing of it.
We didn't think nothing of it. It was just some noisemaker that about 3 months in, your dad had said, if I hear that one more time, I'm breaking it into pieces. And he did the next time he shot it in the house.
That's exactly right. Well, you're on the right path. Is there a trivia today?
It is trivia today. Giving away two rounds of golf to Ocala Municipal Golf Club. You a big golfer, Dan?
Nope, not at all. So I think I'll pass on this one today.
You can always give.
You should try to win it and then, you know, tell me to give it to somebody or something.
Okay, I can do that.
Come on, give it a shot. You want geography, history, or science and nature?
Let's do history today.
History. Oh, this is so easy. God, he's going to win so easy. Who accused Supreme Court nominee Clarence Thomas of sexual harassment?
Anita Hill.
Ding, 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 ding. See? Now, where do you teach high school?
I teach high school at a school called Silver River Mentoring and Instruction.
There you go. So your boss may be able to use these.
Yep, he'll use them. He likes to play golf. That'll be nice.
Two rounds of golf at Ocala Municipal Golf Club right there just for playing Tribune.
Really appreciate it.
So did you hear the story I was talking about the political correctness? Now, you're a teacher.
I just want to know, that the same mothers also protest Barbie?
Because she's the most unrealistic body in the world.
Of course. I heard you say that. I'm like, they must be protesting Barbie, too.
What was it? Somebody said if Barbie's was on a real size woman, the way she is on a doll, her waist would be like a 22 and her boobs would be like a 44G or something. It's some way unrealistic thing.
Right, exactly.
But nobody's upset with Barbie. She's been an institution for years.
Yeah.
Sometimes you just got to realize people are trying to be funny. They're not trying to make a statement.
Yeah, I was surprised by it when you read what it was. I'm like, that's all?
Yeah, I know. When I first read this story, and I mean, it's on all the wires. It's on the AP's got it, Reuters has got it. And I'm like, really? How is this a news story?
Well, these little girls, when they grow up, they'll understand the joke.
Yeah, dear Santa, this year, please give me a big fat bank account and a slim body. Please don't mix those two up like you did last year.
I think it's funny.
That's funny.
Yeah, that's funny, and I know funny.
I do. I think I know funny, too. Hey, Dan, thanks for playing Tribune Ed Tuesday with Tom.
Hey, thanks. Keep up the good work, guys. I really appreciate it. Thank you.
Yep. We just sometimes get out of whack with this political correctness. When is it? Eventually, anything you say is going to offend somebody.
I don't care.
I offended a guy one time on this show.
I'm going to say what I feel like.
I offended a guy one time on this show because I said Arthur Pistorius, the guy that just got convicted of killing his girlfriend,
mm-hmm.
should not be allowed to run against people with legs in the Olympics. I said he shouldn't be allowed to. And some guy wrote, you don't understand, he has no legs. I said, I understand perfectly. The man is a double amputee. I got that. He runs in the Special Olympics.
Mm-hmm.
Well, he runs fast enough to compete against people with legs. Yes, and he can't get a calf cramp, can he? He can't turn an ankle and break a foot, can he? So he has distinct disadvantages. He has no legs. But when he's running on those sleds, he has a distinct advantage, too. He can't break an ankle, and he can't get a calf cramp. So where do you draw the line? Whose advantage is more important? And I got crucified by guy texted Buddy, wrote Buddy, said a buddy should take my hillbilly rear end off the radio, that I didn't get it, blah, blah, blah. I think I got it fine. I think that I showed that there was a distinct advantage to running in the Olympics and on those pieces of metal without having muscles and feet. Yeah, big disadvantage too. But this guy got upset because of what I thought, because it didn't agree with what he thought. And that's our problem these days, is we can't, if you don't agree with what somebody says, you must be wrong. We can't agree that all of us can have differences of opinions, and then we work through those. It's just if we don't agree, we must be wrong. And that's a problem. And this sign's just another one of that. Just another. We'll have a break. We'll go to break. This is another example of somebody didn't agree with something, so they think it needs to be taken down. Well, how about it doesn't need to be taken down? How about you don't need to take it so seriously? That's how I see it. You're freaking out. A mom, listen to what some of these moms put on Facebook when they saw this at Dillard's in Fort Lauderdale. She said, what did it say? What would a little girl want with a bank account? Shopper Sally Stewart asked WPTV. Let me tell you something. Little girls now want a bank account. They want the cash. It gives the wrong message about having a slim body. That's not the message we want to give our kids. No, we want to tell our kids, be overweight, obese, 300-pounders. Is that what you're saying? So you're saying you don't want to tell your kids to be slim. So you go ahead. Eat 3 or 4 layer cakes every day. Be 400 pounds by the time you're 12 years old. Is that the message you want to send to a little kid?
Not necessarily.
How about let's say the message we want to send is that you be a parent and not worry about what a sign might tell a kid. How about you be a parent and tell a kid why that sign's not right, in your opinion? Coming up next, more Trivia Night Tuesday with Tom. Plus, I'll get you set up for the 4 o'clock hour. Buddy Martin joins us in right here on 1370 AM, 96.3 FM. We're live and local. The Source.
Commercial bank approval. Vehicle purchase price of fixed rate allowance.
Fumble. I was so busy making my fantasy football picks that I forgot to stock up on inventory, and now I need cars fast, so I'm calling for an inventory blitz. Chris Spears here from Prestige Auto Sales. This month, bring me in your old car, and you could score the nicer, newer ride you've been fantasizing about for just $10 down.
Sack your old car.
And start driving the nicer, newer car of your dreams for just $10 down. Don't get fouled by past credit problems.
Our For the People credit approval process is the game changer you've been waiting for.
We huddle up the banks and lenders to help you get approved and back in the game. So stop driving a car you hate.
Punt it and drive a nicer, newer car for just $10 down today.
I'm throwing in a Hail Mary to make my month, and I need your help. Trade in your old car, and you could drive for just $10 down. But don't wait till the clock runs out. This deal is over when my inventory is full. I'm Chris Spears, and I'm a dealer for the people.
Visit us at Prestige Auto Sales or call 694-1234. Yes, 694-1234. See you at Prestige.
Mayhem is everywhere.
I'm the football your buddy fired through your windshield. The cooler that tumbled out of a pickup and onto the hood of your car. If you're a football fan, eventually, we're gonna meet. So get Allstate, where agents help keep you protected from mayhem. Like me.
Are you in good hands?
Hey, this is Kevin McDonald, your local Allstate agent. Call me at 622-2333, and let's make sure you're in good hands.
Eye Care Center of Ocala is centered on patient satisfaction. Our friendly doctors and staff are here to serve all of your family's eye care needs under one roof. Our optometric physicians take great pride in offering every patient the absolute best in vision care, utilizing state-of-the-art technology. We're located about 2 miles west of I-75 on State Road 200. You can schedule an appointment for the Eye Care Center by going to www.eyecarecenterofocala.com, or you can call us at 352-512-0560.
Fox News Ready Go, I'm Pam Husso. He says he's proof that the spread of Ebola can be stopped. Dr. Craig Spencer, who's been released from a New York hospital.
Spencer tested positive for the virus on October 23rd, shortly after returning from Guinea, where he was working with Doctors Without Borders.
Fox News Ready Go's Jessica Gallagher, Mayor Bill de Blasio calls it a good day for New York.
When he was himself afflicted, he showed us an example of strength, courage, dignity.
Hundreds of people in the U.S. are still being monitored for the disease. America pauses for Veterans Day.
Let's celebrate our troops, our veterans, their families, by telling their stories.
Defense Secretary Chuck Hagel at the Vietnam Veterans Memorial. To decide a Senate race, thousands of outstanding ballots are being counted in Alaska. Republican Dan Sullivan currently leads Democratic incumbent Mark Begich. Fox News, we report, you decide.
Okay, the Atlanta trip. I have the rental car receipt, but no proof that I actually flew there. I have 2 breakfast receipts, but no dinners, and apparently I slept in the lobby because I have nothing from the hotel.
Traveling for work is work enough. Concur makes it easy. Your business travelers take pictures of receipts and submit expense reports from their smartphones. With Concur, they get to throw away the receipts, you get to rule the budget, and everyone goes home happy. Test drive it free at tryconcur.com.
Dentist office, may I help you?
Hi, I'd like to cancel my teeth whitening appointment.
May I ask why?
I found a teeth whitener that works in 5 minutes that I can do from home. It's called Power Swabs.
Hi, I'm John Greenhut, and if you want to whiten your teeth 2 shades in 5 minutes and 6 shades in 7 days, then try Power Swabs. Just swab your teeth and you're done. Try Power Swabs risk-free by calling 1-800-663-5922. That's 1-800-663-5922. 1-800-663-5922.
Each morning, we wake up thankful to live in a free nation with liberty and justice for all. But sometimes those liberties can be put in jeopardy, and you may have questions about what to do or who to call. Let Doc Blanchard of Blanchard, Miriam, Adele, and Kirkland help you find the answers. Attorneys at law since 1974 and located in downtown Ocala. If you have legal issues, don't go it alone. Call 352-732-7218. Blanchard, Miriam, Adele, and Kirkland, helping protect your liberties every day.
Dad's service to our country is something we're all proud of. He made a difference and set a great example. Now it's our turn to honor the sacrifices he made for our family and his country. As Veterans Funeral Specialist, Hires Baxley Funeral Services helped us celebrate Dad's life, and they can help you too. Hires Baxley is here for you during your time of need or when planning for the future. For more information, call 352-484-0891 or visit hires-baxley.com/choice.
Hey, I'm Gary.
And I'm Eric. Did you know that Red Eye Radio is on WOCA The Source every night from 2 to 6 a.m. and it's live?
That's right. No tape shows here.
We know that the news doesn't sleep.
And neither do we. So we're here with you live from 2 till 6 a.m. every weekday. Call us 866-90-RED-EYE. So join me, Gary McNamara.
And me, Eric Harley, every weeknight to discuss the latest in news and entertainment.
Right here on WOCA The Source.
Hey, Matt, I know Sunrise Automotive does auto stuff, but I need some tires for my truck. Can you recommend someone?
Yes, I can. We do that.
No, I mean, I need them installed and balanced and all that.
Yep, we do that.
Well, my son needed his windows tinted.
Yep, we do that.
I need my seat replaced.
Yep, we do that too.
I need a new roofline, a new spoiler, and a new truck.
Yep, we can even do that too.
Okay, I get it. I suppose you can also do a radio show too, huh?
Well, as a matter of fact, join me every Monday at 10 for auto repair with personal care here on The Source.
Of course you do.
Welcome back to the Voice of Ocala. I'm Tom Schmitz, along with Johnny Walker. Hour number one, Trivia Day to Tuesday with Tom. Real quick, the Ocala City Council had a special meeting Monday, unanimously voted to hire John Zobler at $140,000 a year as interim city manager while the city searches for a replacement for former city manager Matt Brower, whose contract was not renewed as of October 31st. In addition to the salary, the city will put another 15% into a pension fund for Zobler, and he will receive $800 a month car allowance. If a permanent city manager other than Zobler is appointed during Zobler's term, he will continue to be employed as assistant city manager for the remainder of his contract. His contract expires May 2nd of 2015. So for all of those who thought we were a rudderless ship, now we have a city manager again. And this is an interim basis, but that's not to say it couldn't become a permanent basis. It's Trivia Day Tuesday with Tom. Your chance to win. Let's see what I want to give away to now.
Tom should be calling back.
What do I want to give away, Johnny? I don't even know what I want to give away. I think I'll give away...
Mojo's?
No, I'll give away Bob Wine's Camellia Gardens. $20 got Bob Wine's Camellia Garden gift certificate. And...
Mojo's. Or Bob.
Two tickets to the Marion Theater.
That sounds good.
So about a $40 value. Bob Wine's Camellia Gardens, $20 gift certificate plus two tickets to Historic Marion Theater. For playing Trivia Night Tuesday with Tom, give us a call 622-9622 for your chance to win. Give us a call, get in on the lines. You can win. I don't know if you heard earlier in the show, but I declared for the first time in 10 weeks that the United States is Ebola free.
Yay.
There are no known Ebola cases being treated in the United States. That came as the all clear came this morning when Dr. Craig Spencer was declared virus free and released from a New York City hospital. So woo, for the first time in 10 weeks, clap your hands, first time in 10 weeks, we are Ebola free in the United States. Because let's be honest, we were all running around crazy, taking all the pasteurized, you know, the evaporated milk off the shelves and grabbing butter and water and, you know, rice and beans. And we were hunkering down in our, like, nuclear bunkers because the world was coming to an end.
Not me. Some people.
We were burning buildings, you know, setting clothes on fire that we thought may have been, you know, evolved. Heck, I thought I had Ebola last week on Monday and Tuesday. I contemplated going buying masks, plastic gloves, so I wouldn't get myself sick.
And me. And Buddy.
I know you're not supposed to make light of the situation. Ebola is a nasty thing.
It is.
But let's remember, folks, more people die annually from mosquitoes. More people die from the flu in this country than they die from Ebola. Hmm. Oh, there are tens of thousands that could die. Yeah, tens of thousands die from the flu every year. Yeah, but we know how to take care of the flu. No, we don't, because people die from it. There's no cure for the flu. The flu can kill you, just like Ebola can kill you. I know it's a terrible, nasty disease, but let's put it in perspective, please. Malaria kills more people every year than Ebola ever will. We know how to stop malaria with those little tents you can buy for $3 and they ship them off to a West African country. See those commercials late night? For your $9 a month, we can buy 13 tents. But they can. Makes a big difference. Mosquito tents over beds at night make a huge difference in malaria outbreaks. Bill Gates and his wife, huge donators of money to wipe out malaria in this world. So while Ebola is a bad thing, and I'm glad that the United States doesn't have a case of Ebola right now, let's remember more people die from the flu every year than die from Ebola. Understand that this cold snap that we're going through up in the Northeast and everything, one person has died from Ebola inside the United States. There'll be hundreds that die from exposure to the elements in this freezing weather across the United States. There are families that are starving that won't make it through the winter. People that will die from starvation and exposure to the elements that are homeless. That's much more dangerous on a day-to-day basis than Ebola is, in my opinion. Yeah, but Ebola came from West Africa. Yeah, freezing to death came from being outside. Terminated Tuesday with Tom, 1370 AM, 96.3 FM. Give us a call, 622-9622 for your chance to win.
Nobody's calling me.
They don't like you, Johnny. That's what it is.
Yeah, they do.
Two tickets to the historic Marion Theater plus a $20 gift certificate to Bob Wine's Camellia Garden. Give us a call, 622-9622. Answer one trivia question and you're the winner. Dan's already won today.
Yep. Tom,
see if you can join.
Tom never called back.
Tom called during the break and said he'd call back. We got nothing from Tom. Maybe we can guilt him into calling. 622-9622 for your chance to win. Usually, when the police get called out somewhere because they're screaming coming from an apartment, that's not a good thing.
Nope, never. Mm-mm.
Oslo, Norway, the police were called out from screams and howls in an apartment. I'll tell you what, those screams and howls, what was going on in that apartment coming up next. But right now, let's go to the phone lines. Who do we have? Hi, caller. Who's this?
Tom.
Hey, Tom, how are you? See, I told you I could guilt him into calling back. See? Hey, Tom, how are you today?
Doing good.
Tom, You a political correct guy, or you just wish it would go away and everybody would, you know, get back
just
to
go
living?
Away.
Yeah, just go away. That's a, you know, let me say whatever
don't
I want to say.
just leave.
Exactly. I didn't say you had to go away mad. Just go away.
Yeah.
Exactly. I agree with you, Tom. Let's play Trivia Night Tuesday with Tom. Two tickets to the Historic Marion Theater and a $20 gift certificate to Bob Wine's Community Gardens. You want geography, history, or science?
Let's try history.
What country did Ivan the Terrible lead?
Ivan the Terrible.
5 seconds.
He led Romania.
Ooh, so close. He led Russia. Russia. Hey, thanks for playing Trivia Night Tuesday with Tom. Tom, that doesn't sound right. Thanks for playing Trivia Night Tuesday with Tom. Tom, have a good afternoon.
All right, man. Take care.
Just didn't sound right, did it? Tom, have a good afternoon. Thanks for playing Trivia Night Tuesday with Tom.
Tom.
Tom. Isn't there a band instrument called a tom-tom? I think so.
What?
I think there's like a drum called the tom-tom.
No, the GPS.
I know there's a GPS called the tom-tom. Oh, okay. You're so 21st century. You're born in what, like 1995, 96, 97?
Yeah.
97. What was I doing in 1997?
I don't know.
I was in my second year of graduate school.
Oh, my.
I was in my third year of graduate school. I was about to finish.
That's good.
Yeah, so. Trivia Night to Tuesday with Tom, 622-9622 for your chance to win. So these blood-curdling screams are coming out of this apartment. The police show up. They surround the place. Obviously, somebody's being beaten in here or somebody's being murdered or held against their will. I mean, you can tell from the screams and yelling that this is what's going on. So the police approach the door. They had received several calls for the people, screams and all coming from the apartment. I'm going to tell you what they found when they opened the apartment door right after this. Who do we have on the line? Hi, caller. Who's this?
This is Chris.
Hey, Chris. How are you?
Oh, pretty good.
So are you a political correct guy, Chris, or you wish they'd just go away?
No, not really. No, I'm tired of it.
Yeah, just go away. That's all I'm asking you.
Yep.
Let's play Trivia Night Tuesday with Tom. History, geography, or science?
Let's try history.
History. What 19th century industrialist made his fortunes in railroads and helped fund a Tennessee university?
Oh, goodness.
5 seconds.
That would be, I don't know, Vanderbilt?
Correct, sir.
That sounds good.
Chris, if you'll hang on the line, let Johnny get your information. He'll tell you how to pick up your prizes. It's just
Thank
that
you.
Easy. Vanderbilt. It's just that easy. So you got the screams coming from the apartment. The police patrol arrived to investigate. They get up there. They're at the place. They get the door open. They get the door open and all. They find out the screams are because the occupant of the apartment is mad because he keeps losing to his computer-generated chess game. He's screaming and hollering like he's being murdered, like he's being under attack, and all of it's because his computer chess game keeps beating him. All of that because the computer chess game beats him. That's why he's screaming, because the computer chess game beat him. Not because he's being hurt or anything. The computer game's beating him, and he gets angry. So now we got people beating on the window out here while we're live on the radio.
People are scaring you today.
Let's take a break. When we come back, I'll give you, special kind of stupid point. Always got one of those on Tuesday. You listen to Trivia Night Tuesday with Tom, 1370 AM, 96.3 FM. We're live and local on The Source.
If you've been hearing about the crowded Eaton's Beach Sandbar and Grill and were worried because you couldn't get in, I've got some good news for you. Seating is now available. While you're there, look up Chef Dave Del Rio. He'll buy you a drink. Now is the time for you to finally see firsthand what your friends are talking about at Eaton's Beach Sandbar and Grill. Try Chef Dave's tantalizing Floriziana menu. Check out those gorgeous legwear sunsets. Eaton's Beach Sandbar and Grill on beautiful legwear. Seating now available. Stay with us and sleep better at the Sleep Inn and Suites of Ocala Bellevue, located next door to Don Garlitz Museum and a few minutes from Florida Horse Park. Our award-winning, newly refreshed Sleep Inn and Suites offers comfy, clean rooms, free fast Wi-Fi, and service with a smile. Start your day with a deluxe hot breakfast and unwind in our heated outdoor pool. Our convenient 24-hour fitness and business centers allow you to stay on track whether you're here to play or to work. That's Sleep Inn and Suites Ocala Bellevue, proud sponsor of Marion County High School Football.
My name is Bo Briggs. I'm a sixth-generation Ocala, and I practice law with my father at the Briggs Law Firm. Over the years, we've seen many changes to Ocala and many changes in our profession. What has not changed is our commitment to our clients. You will speak with and get to know your attorney. That will never change. A lawyer will personally handle your case, not a paralegal. So if you've been injured in an accident and would appreciate personal attention, you can reach us at 671-4600 or learn more at thebriggslawfirm.com.
Nestled in the heart of horse country, just off I-75 exit 354, the award-winning and newly refreshed Howard Johnson Inn of Ocala invites you to pamper yourself in one of our comfy guest rooms. Enjoy our free and fast Wi-Fi, heated outdoor swimming pool, 24-hour fitness center, and our deluxe continental breakfast. Other on-site amenities include a restaurant, putt-putt golf, and a car wash. Go happy, go Hojo at the Howard Johnson Inn of Ocala, proud sponsor of Friday Night High School Football on WOCA, The Source.
Look who just walked in the room, Joel Wiesner from What's Up Ocala. Hey, Joel, I'm looking for something to do this weekend. You got any ideas?
Absolutely. Check out our event calendar online at www.whatsupocala.com, and there is plenty of events there for you. Daily news updates to event reviews and magazine articles.
Really?
We've organized it all in one place online for you to cut through all of the hassle of finding something to do this weekend. We have a daily event calendar, a bi-monthly magazine, and we also do daily news articles.
All right, Joel, that's perfect. Thanks so much.
Yeah, whatsupocala.com.
Hi, my name is Dr. Erica Alstein with A Better You Healthcare Acupuncture and Eastern Medicine. As primary care physicians, we use acupuncture to treat back pain, arthritis, migraines, allergies, high blood pressure, thyroid disorders, hormone imbalances, stress, and more using all natural medical therapies. We treat the source of your problems, not just your symptoms. For more information, go to abetteryouhealthcare.com or call today to set up your appointment, 352-615-5566.
Good credits, bad credits. It's none of our business because we're not an auto dealer. We're not a bank. We're not your mother. We're OcalaForSale.com, Marion County's marketplace for cars, trucks, and SUVs. We've got thousands of sellers standing by to take your call. No middleman. But hurry, don't walk, don't run. Just sit down and log on to OcalaForSale.com.
Prices and inventory change daily. Offer does not include dealer upcharge. Undercutting, rust proofing, factory surcharge, or delivery fee. See website for details.
You've got a garden and we've got a show for you, called You've Got a Garden with your host, Master Gardener Carol Ann Baldwin. Carol Ann answers your questions about your flowers, your veggies, your grass, your trees, even questions about your bugs. And she's only on WOCA, so don't miss Carol Ann Baldwin and You've Got a Garden each Tuesday from 9 a.m. to 10 a.m. right here on WOCA The Source.
We are The Source, WOCA.
Let's go right back out of the phone lines. Last caller of the day, Steve. Hi, Steve. How are you?
Good. How you doing?
Good, Steve. Trivinator Tuesday with Tom. Your chance to win a $10 gift card to Mojo's Grill and Catering Company. You want geography, history, or science and nature?
Let's go with history.
History. Whose presidential campaign used the phrase, "It's the economy, stupid"? Whose presidential campaign used this phrase, "It's the economy, stupid"? 5 seconds.
Oh, Jimmy Carter.
Oh, sorry, Bill Clinton. Bill Clinton. Thanks, Steve, for playing Trivia Tuesday with Tom.
All right, thank you.
Wrap it up, hour number one. Coming up in hour number two, Chef Dave Del Rio of Eaton's Beach Sandbar and Grill joins Buddy Martin along with Cindy Nicholson of Mark's Prime Steakhouse and Seafood. Yep. They'll be here for the restaurant and food show. And then in the 5 o'clock hour.
See him walking up right now.
The 5 o'clock hour, it's all about sports as we're joined by Dave Cloninger from South Carolina, talking UF South Carolina football, and then John Cooper from Saturday Down South talking about the football playoffs. All that coming up. But we end the hour with a special kind of stupid.
That's always great.
You got to be a special kind of stupid when this is what you get in trouble for. A Utah man is being held in lieu of $10,000 bails after sheriff and deputies tracked the GPS data on a series of 911 calls to find the man. He was drunk and pointed a rifle at a teenage girl.
Oh.
John Richard Valenzuela was in the Utah County Jail on charge of unlawful detention involving domestic violence, aggravated assault involving domestic violence, criminal mischief involving domestic violence. My computer just decided to die on me. That's never a good thing. Domestic assault for involving domestic violence. All this for pointing a rifle at a 15-year-old girl. What was a 15-year-old girl doing that caused him to point the rifle at her?
I don't know.
Well, this is why he's a special kind of stupid. She was beating him at the game of Battleship. Yep. He went. Wow. He was drunk, went and got a loaded rifle, pointed at the little girl, told her he was going to kill her if she didn't stop beating him at Battleship.
Oh my gosh.
Had won 3 games in a row that were in the middle of a 4th one. She had just, wait for it, sunk his battleship when he retrieved the gun and made the terroristic threats towards a 15-year-old.
Now, is this the father of the girl, the uncle of the girl? Who is this guy?
Family relatives, all they're saying.
Oh, my gosh.
You got to be a special kind of stupid to, in the middle of your 4th battleship game, after a 15-year-old's beating you in 3 of them,
pull out a rifle.
And sinks your battleship, you pull out a rifle and threaten to kill her if she continues to beat you at battleship. That's a special kind of stupid right there, people. Coming up next, Buddy Martin joins us, restaurant and food show, Chef Dave Del Rio. Eat the Beat Sandbar Grill, Cindy Nicholson from Mark's Prime Steakhouse and Seafood, right here on 1370 AM, 96.3 FM, WOCA, The Source.
Like a good neighbor, State Farm is there. And so is State Farm agent Angie Lewis, working hard to serve her community as a citizen and insurance agent. Angie wants to help you as you adjust your insurance needs to your life, from everything to helping educate your teen driver to protecting your family against everyday risk. She wants to change the way you perceive insurance by developing relationships with their clients, which is why Angie and her staff are proud to be a part of so many good causes in Ocala. In turn, she has chosen to single out those who step up as leaders. Each month on The Voice of Ocala, Angie spotlights a good neighbor, saluting those who give exceptional service or do random acts of kindness to others. For this, Angie was written up in State Farm's National Magazine. Angie also supports local businesses with a regular Biz Buzz.
Hi, I'm State Farm agent Angie Lewis. Come see me and my team for all your insurance and financial needs in the beautiful downtown historic district, 416 East Fort King Street, or call 291-2444.
Does osteoarthritis bring frustration with every step? Do pain and stiffness affect your everyday activities? If so, you may be interested in a research study for the treatment of pain associated with osteoarthritis. RentStar Medical Research is conducting a research study of an investigational medication for individuals between the ages of 40 and 75 and who have been treated for the pain associated with osteoarthritis for at least 3 months. Qualified participants will receive study-related medical care and investigational medication. Compensation for time and travel will be provided. To learn more about this osteoarthritis study, please call RenStar Medical Research in Ocala at 352-629-5800. Again, that's 352-629-5800.
If you've been hearing about the crowded Eaton's Beach Sandbar and Grill and were worried because you couldn't get in, I've got some good news for you. Seating is now available. While you're there, look up Chef Dave Del Rio. He'll buy you a drink. Now is the time for you to finally see firsthand what your friends are talking about at Eaton's Beach Sandbar and Grill. Try Chef Dave's tantalizing Floresiana menu. Check out those gorgeous Lakeware sunsets. Eaton's Beach Sandbar and Grill on beautiful Lakeware. Seating now available.
Let's face it, nowadays it can be hard to find American-made products, and that's something that Cabinet Sales of North Florida is well aware of. That's why they're an authorized dealer of Wellborn Cabinetry, family-owned and American-made since 1961. Cabinet Sales of North Florida is your answer for complete turnkey kitchen remodels and whole house cabinetry. Their cabinets are finished with solvent-based enamels for a long-lasting finish that's second to none. Available in an incredible selection of door styles and colors to choose from to turn your dream kitchen into a reality. In-house design and drawing services are available. Come by and see our displays for yourself at the Floors of the Villages, 3935 County Road 216 in Oxford, or Exquisite Design Kitchen and Bath in Bellevue, right across the street from the Bellevue Library. So whether you're looking for bookcases, kitchen, bath, or outdoor kitchen, Cabinet Sales of North Florida is your one-stop source of quality cabinets. For a free estimate, call 352-427-2647. That's 352-427-2647. Cabinet Sales of North Florida.
Experience Christmas at Gaylord Palms, November 15th through January 4th, with ICE, featuring the Nutcracker. Relive your favorite scenes from the classic ballet, hand-carved in more than 2 million pounds of ice sculptures and slides. Enjoy a special bonus area, the Frostbite Factory, and watch artisans from Harbin, China, carve amazing ice sculptures before your eyes. Your awe-inspiring experience concludes with the wonder of the Nativity in Ice. For tickets and packages, visit christmas@gaylordpalms.com.
News Talk 1370. WOCA invites you to discover your full business potential. News Talk Radio is the perfect environment for your advertising. WOCA's News Talk format pinpoints information hungry, better educated, high income adults. So use us to talk to them. Call 732-8000. 732-8000. We're Ocala News Talk Radio. News Talk 1370. WOCA.
Hey, I'm Gary.
And I'm Eric. Did you know that Red Eye Radio is on WOCA The Source every night from 2 to 6 a.m. and it's live?
That's right. No tape shows here.
We know that the news doesn't sleep.
And neither do we. So we're here with you live from 2 till 6 a.m. every weekday. Call us 866-90-RED-EYE. So join me, Gary McNamara.
And me, Eric Harley, every weeknight to discuss the latest in news and entertainment.
Right here on WOCA The Source.
Broadcasting from the Paddock Mall Studios, this is WOCA, Ocala, Gainesville, The Villages, 1370 AM, 96.3 FM, The Source.
Fox News Radio, I'm Jane Metzler. Right now, it's a war of words in the Middle East. Palestinian President Mahmoud Abbas accuses Israel of leading the region toward a religious war. In a nationwide address, Israel's Prime Minister Benjamin Netanyahu accuses Abbas of inciting violence, saying through a translator,
instead of calming tempers, he is inflaming them. Instead of telling the truth, he is disseminating lies.
This country honoring our veterans on this Veterans Day. Those vets marching down New York's Fifth Avenue, 150,000 expected at the National Mall, for a free concert featuring performers like Bruce Springsteen and Metallica. Her now ex-husband worth $17 billion.
Judge in Oklahoma awards Sue Ann Hamm $995.5 million in her divorce from Continental Resources oil company boss Harold Hamm.
Fox News Radio's Chris Foster, Fox News. We report, you decide.
Okay, the Atlanta trip. I have the rental car receipt, but no proof that I actually flew there. I have two breakfast receipts, but no dinners, and apparently I slept in the lobby because I have nothing from the hotel.
Traveling for work is work enough. Concur makes it easy. Your business travelers take pictures of receipts and submit expense reports from their smartphones. With Concur, they get to throw away the receipts, you get to rule the budget, and everyone goes home happy. Test drive it free at tryconcur.com.
Dentist office, may I help you?
Hi, I'd like to cancel my teeth whitening appointment.
May I ask why?
I found a teeth whitener that works in 5 minutes that I can do from home. It's called Power Swabs.
Hi, I'm John Greenhut, and if you want to whiten your teeth 2 shades in 5 minutes and 6 shades in 7 days, then try Power Swabs. Just swab your teeth and you're done. Try Power Swabs risk-free by calling 1-800-663-5922. That's 1-800-663-5922. 1-800-663-5922.
Yes, it's time again for Buddy Martin. Call him up and tell him what you're thinking. But be kind because he's doing the best he can.
I'm just sick of all the amateur stuff, you know? I mean, like, if I'm paying top dollar, I want a little production value, you know? Like some editing, transition, something, some music.
Don't worry, we didn't leave you.
He's gone. He's not gone. That's the whole point. He's never gone.
Our bosses say we gotta stay.
Check out the name tag. You're in my world now, Grandma.
Bow to your sensei. Bow to your sensei.
It's time for the second hour of The Voice of Ocala.
Hoo-ah!
You ever come across anything like time travel?
Come on, stick around. It's free.
If you win, you win. If you lose, you still win.
Hello, welcome to the Restaurant Food Show, Hour 2 of The Voice of Ocala. Glad to be with you on this day. If you're hearing this show on Tuesday or hearing this show on Friday, you get a double treat here at the Restaurant Food Show. And today, our co-hosts are Dave Del Rio from Eaton's Beach Sandbar and Grill. He's got his drink in hand, some kind of strawberry specialty he got down.
Strawberry lemonade.
There you go. And as usual, the mad dasher, Cindy Nicholson, is... Hello, Danielle. She made it. She's fine. She's there. Good. From Mark's Steak and Seafood and one of our favorite places. What a great time to be though downtown at Mark's on the porch right now. This is the perfect weather for that.
It's gorgeous.
Isn't it,
Christmas
though?
Is coming, even though we still have Thanksgiving.
Yeah.
To get through, but it is gorgeous to see it lit up. The weather's beautiful. The porch is looking great. I'm all about the fall.
We have to find a way to get Dave down there. It may be difficult. We may have to close down his restaurant and bring him. But I tell you, Dave, I love the interaction of the people on this show, the co-host, seeing Randy Quinches down at La Cuisine last week, eating the food there, loving it. Of course, Elodie and Patrice, they like to sample the fare. Cindy taking her dad, her parents down to the restaurant. And now you got to come down here to go at least taste a little of that French food and that fine cuisine she's got at Mark's and on that front porch. It is one of the top 25 experiences in Ocala. Trust
it's not
trust
from me. Not wanting to go. No. I've been locked down, but I'm ready. Let me tell you, I'm ready to bust out.
I feel you.
I'm ready to bust out.
I'm thinking we should have you call in sick one day.
Yeah, I might have to do that.
Doesn't work that way, does it?
No.
Well, today, folks, we know it's a very special day, Veterans Day. We want to everybody here wants to express their love and their appreciation for the men and women of the armed services who've done so much over our lifetimes to protect us, protect our land, protect our way of living. And we cannot say it enough times or with greater emphasis to say than we are deeply from the bottom of our hearts. We appreciate this on this Veterans Day. And I know Randy, I've got Randy on my mind. Randy just got back from the Love Boat cruise, as a matter of fact. Randy Quinches and his wife, yeah.
Rested,
and he's all ready to go. Dave, you had a special breakfast this morning. Tell us about it.
We did. We had a special breakfast. We had a prayer breakfast at the beach, it was in honor of Veterans Day. We had a super speaker, unbelievable, a highly decorated Air Force test pilot, Dan Isabel. And it was such a fascinating story of the things that this man, you know, invented and carried through, including GPS and the way the way pilots plan how they fly, plan their flight plans. You know, when he got there, they were still using paper and protractors, and he put it on the computer, and then it went everywhere.
Amazing.
But we had 80 people show up, and of course, we provided a free breakfast to everybody. I've been up since 4, making sausage and biscuits gravy and,
that's
you know,
awesome.
All kinds of stuff. But it was a wonderful thrill for us.
Well, that's great. I know, Cindy, you have a great appreciation, of course, for the veterans as well.
And I do. You know, you're right. They get overlooked. We seem to forget what they do for us in our society. And they've been around forever, and we seem to just kind of bypass it quickly without stopping and making sure we take care of them. Danielle and I have always believed in pay forward. So when I do see someone out in military uniform, when I see them in the dining room on a date and they come in all dressed, I do pick up their tab. I make a point just to say thanks.
Awesome.
That's my father's nice. 20 years in the Coast Guard, retired. So it does hit home to me, but I'm a believer in making sure my daughter understands.
Good for you.
Of where they came from.
Good parenting by you. And by the way, I think we all have a relative of some kind.
I think we do.
Who represents something about patriotism in the military.
Yes.
I know in my case, it's an uncle who was shot up in Normandy. And the great story about Uncle Harry is that he had obviously he had terrible pains in his legs all the time, but he worked in construction and he worked as a bank guard. In later years, it got difficult, but he always had every year at Christmas, he put up a Christmas tree and put on a Santa Claus outfit and had the kids come to his house and he gave them candy. And they would be in Bradenton, Florida, there'd be 6-7 blocks of cars coming by. And this is in the 70s.
That's awesome.
Remember the military? Remember the energy shortage we had when the gas prices went outside? Yeah. And electricity cost a fortune.
Yes.
One year, they gave up their Christmas in order to be able to afford to run the lights on this gigantic Christmas tree because they couldn't afford any other way. But they gave it to the kids. So I always think of Uncle Harry, you know, and how he served us, and then kept on serving, you know, doing things for the community. So I think that's really cool. And so again, everybody's got an Uncle Harry or a dad or somebody out there that served, and we appreciate it. We want to say thank you very much, and we could spend the whole hour talking about veterans, but we do have to talk about food today. So I even talked about food yesterday on my Dr. Buddy segment. I had a little bit of a kind of a rant on people who overdo the healthy food thing, you know, which I think is wonderful. I'm all for it. That's good. But this article I read talked about how some people make their life, build their whole life around this particular kind of eating. And not only do they have difficulty for themselves, but they make people around them very uncomfortable with it sometimes. Mm-hmm. Like, let's all go to, no, I can't eat that. Let's go to the spaghetti. No, I can't have that. Does that have a crispy green? Oh, no, I wouldn't put that in my mouth. You know, don't you think so, Cindy?
I absolutely agree. And without naming names, I do have some in my family that are extreme vegetarians. And it is difficult to do a holiday meal or even to go somewhere because you're stuck standing on the corner going, what about this one? No, we can't. Is what's there to eat on that one? It does become a production. You don't really think about it until you have to stop in the middle of going, wait a minute, what is wrong with the basics? Oh, no, I don't eat any of that. So it is. It's much more prevalent today than it was certainly 5-10 years ago.
I mean, Randy, I'm from the school of like, here's your food, sit down and eat it. That's it. I better clean your plate, by the way.
Exactly.
And you're lucky to have that. You know what I mean?
Yeah.
I know that's maybe not the way today because everybody has a certain kind of food cooked a certain way and what you can't have. And I appreciate healthy food. That's great. But let's not try to change the world into eating like they eat, because we eat differently, don't we?
We do. And, you know, and even at our restaurant, you know, I try to have, you know, I have some vegetarian options and I have, you know, the gluten-free options and some different. And I do my best to make sure that everybody has a, you know, has something that they can enjoy at our place. But, I mean, at the end of the day, though, you know, I want to feed people good, wholesome food. You know, come in, eat, enjoy yourself, and have a great time, and that's what it's about. It's in moderation, in my opinion, unless you have a severe allergy or an allergy, a food allergy, that's different. I'm just talking about, you know, lifestyle trends. Okay, you know, in moderation, that should be the trend. Moderation.
That's very well said. It's not always bigger is better. I'm a bigger believer in you can't get me to have a 40-ounce soda cup. I don't need the monster cup, but I want to have it in moderation. I want to have my cheeseburger and fry in moderation.
Yeah, and that's the, and by the way, speaking of which, there's a new restaurant opening in town. That's going to be called I believe it's Burger 21.
It is.
It's going to be out there, the old Carmichael's.
Mm-hmm.
Some of the same Ken, of course, is going to be involved in it.
Very excited.
I mean the Five Guys has been a big hit. Obviously,
huge.
There's these other things like Burger Fi I mentioned on this program down in. In Wonder Park, these burger places are popping up. These sort of high-end burger places.
Mm-hmm.
What do you think? Is this something that's a trend?
Oh yeah, it's definitely a trend, and it's coming along. Yeah, Burger 21. I don't think you can compare Burger 21 to Five Guys.
No, completely different. Completely different.
Yeah, I know the guys from Burger 21, and they have some great. They're very innovative. They have some great stuff in there. So if you want a different kind of hamburger, you know that's the place to go. You know, I mean, it's a great hamburger, and they do a great job. But yes, hamburgers are hot.
And they've been around a long time.
Oh yeah, yeah.
Ocala had a restaurant called Cheeseburger. I had Danielle's fifth birthday there. That's why I remember it.
Cheeseburger, cheeseburger.
Cheeseburger, cheeseburger on Las Olas Drive. And that's what it was known for. But it was just a good old-fashioned burger. And it was great at it. And the same with Backyard Burgers was in Fort Lauderdale. And they were a great independent that did well. So I'm thrilled to see more unique independents, not so much a chain coming along. I know 21 is a chain, but I like that more uniqueness about things.
Now, you both serve burgers.
Yes.
And Sandy, I haven't had yours yet, Dave. I will, but I've had yours, Sandy. It's a big, had it recently.
Prime beef.
You took it home and actually cut it, and we had it home for two, you know.
Yeah.
But you have it's quite a nice burger. It's very unusual for a high-end steakhouse to have a really great burger.
Right.
It's not that.
It's all prime beef that's been ground.
Yeah.
So it's a very unique high-end burger.
And I like the tomato and the cut slice. I like the fresh onion and all that stuff. Dave, what is yours like? I haven't experienced it
yet. Well, we have a great burger, too. As a matter of fact, the same people that grind the beef for Five Guys grinds my beef.
Okay.
And it's a 6-ounce hamburger, so it's big but not giant. We put it on a brioche bun. A brioche is a lighter French roll, so it gives it some flavor. And I've got some crazy burgers. I've got them, you know, I've got it loaded down with a pimento cheese, a low country burger. I've got the jazz burger that has bacon and peanut butter on it, and a smokehouse burger that's got smoked cheddar cheese, smoked applewood bacon, and pulled pork, smoked pork.
Smoked pork, a hamburger.
Oh, that's,
now that's what you call it.
That sounds yummy.
That's an incredible hamburger.
Wow.
Yes.
I got to try that.
Yes, you should.
Come down to your place, and we're going to take a break. Come back. I'm going to ask you, for those folks who don't know, because both of you get quite busy certain times of the year. Maybe we could help our listeners out who want to go to Mark's, who want to go to Eaton's Beach Sandbar and Grill, and take part. But maybe could find the time of the day that's the best to go. If you can make sure you get a seat, because it gets a little busy in wintertime, as we all know.
Mm-hmm.
So maybe you guys can help me out with a little bit of that information, and we'll talk about the holidays again. What's new for the holidays? Any food? The weather's getting cool. Any cool weather food? What about soup, etc.? We'll get the full drill here from both Dave Del Rio of Eaton's Beach Sandbar and Grill and Cindy Nicholson from Mark's Prime Steakhouse and Seafood on the Restaurant and Food Show right here in the Voice of Ocala, 1370 AM, 96.3 FM, WOCA, The Source.
Being the Culligan Man is not easy, because he works hard every day for you here in North Central Florida. Whether you need bottled water delivery for your office, a home water softener, or water infiltration system, the Culligan Man can help you. At Culligan North Florida, we have dozens of softener and filtration options, along with a host of media tank sizes. Depending on the exact hardness and usage of your water, we determine the size of softener you're going to need. And if you're on city or well water in one of our local areas, the in-home water analysis is absolutely free. If your needs are for the home, call Ocala Water Conditioning, 352-291-5900. For home or business bottled water in Ocala, call Ocala Bottled Water, 352-291-5900. Culligan of North Florida, a proud sponsor of Florida State Football, heard right here on WOCA, The Source.
The next drink is on Dave Del Rio at Eaton's Beach Sandbar and Grill. Just ask him for it. But don't wait. Show up soon, because this offer isn't going to last very long. Eaton's Beach Sandbar and Grill will be filling up fast, because their friends from the north are headed back that way soon. The good news is that seating is now available, and Dave's buying the first drink. Have you been hearing about the crowd at Eaton's Beach Sandbar and Grill and couldn't get in? Now you can see firsthand what your friends have been talking about. Great food. Try Chef Dave's tantalizing Floresiana menu. Great location. Check out those gorgeous sunsets over Lake Weir. Great people. Starting with Chef Dave Del Rio, who began his career in 1978. This spicy guy has been instrumental in opening over 100 restaurants. And he's buying you a drink. Eaton's Beach Sandbar and Grill, where there's little or no waiting these days. Come see what started out as Jay Eaton's dream almost 90 years ago. It's more awesome than ever.
Nestled in the heart of horse country, just off I-75, exit 354, the award-winning and newly refreshed Howard Johnson Inn of Ocala invites you to pamper yourself in one of our comfy guest rooms. Enjoy our free and fast Wi-Fi, heated outdoor swimming pool, 24-hour fitness center, and our deluxe continental breakfast. Other on-site amenities include a restaurant, putt-putt, golf, and the car wash. Go happy, go Hojo at the Howard Johnson Inn of Ocala, proud sponsor of Friday Night High School Football on WOCA, The Source.
It's the end of the fiscal year, and that means budget cuts and number crunching. Now's the time of the year you're evaluating your expenses, planning your budget, and finding ways to save money and increase efficiency to maximize profits. DEX Imaging understands and delivers. Call DEX Imaging today for a free document management evaluation. Cutting your office expenses is as easy as calling DEX Imaging, 352-266-0333. Start saving money today and increase your bottom line with DEX Imaging. Printers, copiers, and fax machines that increase office productivity and save you money. No one understands your bottom line better. Call DEX Imaging today, 352-266-0333, or check them out on the web at DEXImaging.com. That's DEXImaging.com, or call 352-266-0333 for your free document management evaluation today.
Dan, did you know that the runway at Ocala's airport is nearly 8,000 feet long?
Why, no, Brad. I did not. Please, tell me more about said runway.
Seriously, it's a big airport.
Yeah, I kind of knew that. So what's your point?
Well, just that most people don't even realize there's an airport, much less one that's big enough for Air Force One to land.
And?
And that Ocala Aviation is based at Ocala International Airport.
So why are you telling me?
So that you can help me get the word out that Ocala Aviation has a fleet of airplanes and is here for them to learn to fly.
And how do you propose we get said message across to so many people at once?
We should put an ad on a good radio station, but yours will do.
Very funny. Well, what do you want to say?
That we offer private, instrument, and even commercial training, all right here in Ocala. They don't even have to go anywhere else. They can do it all right here.
Nope, never work.
Well, then give them the number to call with any questions.
I can't even remember your number.
Yes, you do. 861-7484. How hard is that?
Okay, I'll call you next week and we'll get it started.
Can you remember the number this time?
Yes, 861-7484.
Good boy.
Back on the Restaurant Food Show with Cindy Nicholson from Mark's Prime Steakhouse and Seafood, Dave Del Rio from Eaton's Beach Sandbar and Grill, and Johnny Walker. No, they're not drinking Johnny Walker. He's the intern here running the boards. And we do this every week, twice a week. Glad they should. We should have the microphone on during the breaks. Because we have more.
Oh,
no.
Oh, we will certainly have
Let's
to
see.
Watch.
What was that off-the-record comment, Cindy?
Look at that. Throw me under the bus.
But one thing I will say, we can say generically, is that people who criticize your tastes because they think you're not eating authentic kind of food, like authentic Chinese or authentic Italian or whatever, they say, you shouldn't eat that stuff. If it tastes good to me, why shouldn't it? I don't necessarily have to go to Italy to eat Italian food.
Absolutely.
I mean, I know we can't all be from, you know, from Rome, but I mean, there's some needs in this town still for great restaurants, and we have a couple here already, including the two we just mentioned, and of course La Cuisine and do some great stuff. Harry's does a good job. There's lots of good restaurants. I want to talk about a food experience if I can, and I'd like you to share. I guess Dave can talk about his Charlie's drink. Will be his limit. That's a limit of how many he gets out to do. And Cindy, I know from time to time you get a chance to spin off and have a deal. This is a special thing I want to mention to Mary from Artisanal Dish. Such a, we know, of course, our friend of the show, listens to the show all the time. And I needed to order some takeout,
uh-huh.
You know, because my wife's in bed and I'm not a good cook. So Mary called me up and said, let us bring some food. And I said, okay, what's good? And she said, well, I think you should get this. I said, okay. She brought it out. She personally brought it to my house from way out.
Oh, wow.
At 5 o'clock on a Saturday.
Wow.
I felt terrible, but I couldn't leave, you know. And so she brought this. She brought in the Wagyu beef. She brought in some mac and cheese. It was delicious. She brought in some a medley of vegetables. And I'm forgetting something. And then, of course, there was a great brownie cookie at the end.
Oh.
But it was fabulous. And Mary did that out of a, you know, just because she wanted, she knew we would need the food, and she brought it all out there. I want to say thank you for that. And the food was delicious.
Oh, very sweet.
So have you been out there recently?
I have not. You know what? And I hear great things. I really do. It just, like you said, it's far out
yeah,
there.
Yeah, it is. It's off the beaten path.
Yeah. I got to make that journey to get out there because I do. Some of my staff goes there and they said, they bring me back the menus, tell me what's up, and really good response.
Yeah. And by the way, Dave, this was speak to you because It seemed like up north when I lived in New York State, people thought nothing of driving 15 miles in the suburbs to a restaurant out in the woods someplace, you know? Mm-hmm. And then we did it all the time. It was a destination, mm-hmm. which is kind of what Eaton's Beach is, Sandbar and Grill, is that if you want to take a little drive, you want 20, 25-minute drive, you know, on a beautiful night, you drive down there, take in the scenery of the lake and have a drink and watch the sunset and then have dinner. So you have a destination of one kind, which I think people should know about.
Well, we do have it. We are a destination restaurant. You're not going to just be passing by us and say, oh, that looks like a good place to eat. I mean, we're tucked down in a neighborhood on the lake, you know what I mean? But
you're right. You have to locate it.
So, yeah, you have to find us. And that's kind of special because I know that everybody that's coming there is specifically coming there to eat with us and mm-hmm. to enjoy their time with us. And it's great because you're right. You know, we're constantly doing things to improve the atmosphere and improve the building. We just added garage doors downstairs to the sandbar. When it gets really windy or as it starts to get cold now, we can pretty much airtight that downstairs sandbar area. So that's huge for us. Mm-hmm. You know, because it gets cold, that wind blowing off the lake down there. Nice. But now we can close that down and we've got a great area where you can come and listen to live music and, you know, have some good cocktails from the sandbar. Mm-hmm. But we love to have people come out and just spend time and look around. There's so many things to see, so many, you know, things hanging in the rafters, and it's a destination, and you know, and we want to provide an experience, a great experience, and that's what we're about, because we know people just aren't passing by to stop and see us.
And we talk about on the show time the experience, which is certainly with the history of Eaton's Beach and all the things that you got, the great photos that you put up there,
the Eaton family,
the bike riders and what have you. And Cindy, in your own way, you also have a destination restaurant because people do come from Gainesville, different places, to come to your restaurant, so especially during the holidays.
They do. And you know what? The downtown square, even though it's been there for so many years, it's had its ups and its downs. It's come back and then it's died back off. That it's almost to the people of Marin County that have lived here a long time, became a destination. Oh, I've been in the square in a year, but I'll come during the holidays. So it is that once a year to some of the people that live here who just don't come downtown to try to figure out where to park and spend the day. So it's a different.
It is different. By the way, I want to speak to this issue. Our friend Teddy Goss. You know, of course,
and Teddy and Jerry.
You're good friends, especially. Yes. These are people I went to high school with. I know they're much older than me, by the way. No, I was a prodigy. I was high school when I was eight. So anyway, but I know Teddy's very close friends and Jerry with Cindy, and often come across the street to the restaurant. I want to send out just a condolences. She lost one of her really good friends last week, and a friend of mine, a neighbor I grew up with, a neighbor. Her name was Peggy Graham. Ernie Griggs is his sister, Peggy Graham. I know Teddy was a cheerleader with her. And she just loved her to death. And so we just say RIP to Peggy, who was a great gal. Just
absolutely
great. And it thinks so. Okay, it's holidays. I guess we should probably save this up a little bit later. But I want to talk about what we're going to do besides the ordinary things. We talked about this a couple times on their air already. You know, like I was asking my kids today. My son Brendan's in town, one apart. My daughter Rebecca is here from Pennsylvania, came down from West Reading to help take care of her mom for a week or so. We're talking about, you know, about food and pumpkin spice and cold weather food, whatever, and holiday food. We don't have time to go into great detail in this segment, but when we come back, we will. And also, I want to tell you, we have a special treat today for somebody. Somebody's going to get a $50 gift certificate to Mark's. By simply being able to answer the question that Cindy's going to give us, and it's not that difficult. It can be found on her website, which is what? What's your website?
MarksPrimeSteakhouse.com.
And this is a simple one. Look it up. Johnny will take your call. Not now, but during the break, we'll give it to you. And the first person to call gets $50. And you can get a nice steak for $50 down there and have a nice evening. Go down and bring somebody and, you know, for the two of you to enjoy this great evening downtown at Mark's as well. Let's just give you a hint. Any special spices coming up for the holidays, guys?
Any special spices?
Yeah, like pumpkin spice.
Pumpkin. Yeah. Definitely is coming to play with these.
Yeah.
Cinnamon, nutmeg.
Those are
coming right back.
Yeah. Yeah, they are. You know, I use a lot of fresh herbs anyway. You know, we use a lot of fresh rosemary and fresh thyme and, you know, different herbs. So, those are all sage. That's going to be coming back this holiday season. I've got something I'm going to work with, a little sage that'll be real nice flavor.
So, you know what would be great for you? I just thought about it. When that weather turns cold, downstairs there, hot chocolate would be awesome.
Yeah.
Maybe a little peppermint schnapps in it. You know what I'm saying?
Oh, yeah. I kind of wish it was cold now.
I mean, think about it. When you're cold,
when
you're cold, that's a great drink. I mean, hot chocolate and peppermints. Schnapps is really good stuff, man. So, and for you, by the way, for Christmas lights on the porch, right?
Huge. We do. Do you do hot chocolate? We do hot chocolate by all means. We do white hot chocolate.
White chocolate, hot chocolate. What's in it? Liqueur or?
No, nope. It's just a straight virgin white.
You could have a little if you want to.
You could. We do have quite a few coffee drinks running for the fall and winter.
Yeah.
That have Frangelica, Godiva chocolates in them.
Yeah.
We have quite a few that definitely hit the spot. Godiva. Mm-hmm.
Very good. I mean, how could you not love the holiday season for no other reason than the food? I mean, you know, just think about what great food we have.
We wait all year for certain things.
We really do. And now we have excuses to eat them.
That's right. Sweet potato casserole and turkey. So it's all year we wait for those items to come back.
That's right.
Even though they're here all year, we just don't make them until the fall.
And you don't feel quite as guilty. Oh, it's holidays. Right. I got to eat, right?
That's right.
Did you all have, I know, Dave, you did. Cindy, I think you might, no, you weren't here. When Elodie and Patrice brought in the pumpkin pie. It was a thicker crust on that, and that was had some kind of spice in it too. So I'm not sure.
That was a really nice take on that pie.
Yeah, very good. All right, come back on the other side. Get ready to tune it up. Listen to the show and make sure you listen to this little tip on the trivia question for Cindy Nicholson right here on the Restaurant and Food Show coming up next on the Voice of Ocala, 1370 AM, 96.3 FM, WOCA, the source.
Right on the southwestern corner of the square sits one of the finest dining establishments in Florida, Mark's Prime Steakhouse and Seafood Restaurant. Mark's offers big city dining amenities in a charming and small town setting. It's a rare treat to experience both the ambiance and the exquisite cuisine in a friendly atmosphere. Ocala's finest restaurant serves the finest beef, the freshest seafood, premium wines, and naturally fresh vegetables. From valet parking to splendid service, Mark's offers the complete package. Check it out today. Mark's Prime Seafood and Steakhouse Restaurant.
Stay with us and sleep better at the Sleep Inn and Suites of Ocala Bellevue, located next door to Don Garlitz Museum and a few minutes from Florida Horse Park. Our award-winning, newly refreshed Sleep Inn and Suites offers comfy, clean rooms, free fast Wi-Fi, and service with a smile. Start your day with a deluxe hot breakfast and unwind in our heated outdoor pool. Our convenient 24-hour fitness and business centers allow you to stay on track whether you're here to play or to work. That's Sleep Inn and Suites Ocala Bellevue, proud sponsor of Marion County High School Football.
Let's give it up for old asphalt and a new pair of shoes. Let's give it up for a good rhythm meeting a sweet melody. For a church cookout under clear skies. Let's give it up for good things coming together, like bundling your auto and other policies together with an Allstate agent, which can save you time and keep you better protected. Let's give it up for good.
To receive your comparative insurance quote, contact the McDonald Agency at 622-2333.
If you've been hearing about the crowd at Eaton's Beach Sandbar and Grill and were worried because you couldn't get in, I've got some good news for you. Seating is now available. While you're there, look up Chef Dave Del Rio. He'll buy you a drink. Now is the time for you to finally see firsthand what your friends are talking about at Eaton's Beach Sandbar and Grill. Try Chef Dave's tantalizing Floresiana menu. Check out those gorgeous Legware sunsets. Eaton's Beach Sandbar and Grill on beautiful Legware. Seating now available.
Fox News Radio, I'm Jane Metzler. Right now, it's a war of words in the Middle East. Palestinian President Mahmoud Abbas accuses Israel of leading the region toward a religious war. In a nationwide address, Israel's Prime Minister Benjamin Netanyahu accuses Abbas of inciting violence, saying through a translator,
instead of calming tempers, he is inflaming them. Instead of telling the truth, he is disseminating lies.
This country honoring our veterans on this Veterans Day. Those vets marching down New York's Fifth Avenue, 150,000 expected at the National Mall, for a free concert featuring performers like Bruce Springsteen and Metallica. Her now ex-husband worth $17 billion.
Judge in Oklahoma awards Sue Ann Hamm $995.5 million in her divorce from Continental Resources oil company boss Harold Hamm.
Fox News Radio's Chris Foster, Fox News. We report, you decide.
Okay, the Atlanta trip.
I have the rental car receipt, but no proof that I actually flew there. I have two breakfast receipts, but no dinners, and apparently I slept in the lobby because I have nothing from the hotel.
Traveling for work is work enough. Concur makes it easy. Your business travelers take pictures of receipts and submit expense reports from their smartphones. With Concur, they get to throw away the receipts, you get to rule the budget, and everyone goes home happy. Test drive it free at tryconcur.com.
Dentist office, may I help you?
Hi, I'd like to cancel my teeth whitening appointment.
May I ask why?
I found a teeth whitener that works in 5 minutes that I can do from home. It's called Power Swabs.
Hi, I'm John Greenhut, and if you want to whiten your teeth 2 shades in 5 minutes and 6 shades in 7 days, then try Power Swabs. Just swab your teeth and you're done. Try Power Swabs risk-free by calling 1-800-663-5922. That's 1-800-663-5922. 1-800-663-5922.
Hi, I'm Yvette, and I'm here to tell you a few things about ABC Frederick's Appliance. They sell not only new, but used guaranteed appliances. When you call ABC Frederick's Appliance, they will provide service on what they sell and any appliances that you own. ABC Frederick's Appliance is located in Bellevue, right over the railroad tracks. Call 352-629-5181. That's 352-629-5181. That's 352-629-5181. ABC Frederick's Appliance.
Your home is safe, or is it? AA Lock, Dock, and Security. The name has been a staple in Ocala since 1985. Do you have the right equipment in place to have peace of mind when you are at home or away? AA Lock, Dock, and Security has the right people to install and monitor your home or business. Call today for a free on-site security analysis. Call 867-1965. AA Lock, Dock, and Security, 219 Northwest 10th Street, 867-1965.
Who would you feed if you had 50 chicken sandwiches from Chick-fil-A? WOCA and Chick-fil-A in the Paddock Mall have teamed up to reward one organization with 50 chicken sandwiches as a way of saying thanks for the great work that organization is doing in our community. And we need your help. See, there are so many great people doing great things that we need nominations. You can nominate your own organization or any organization you choose. Simply send an email to WOCA@WOCA.com. And in 350 words or less, tell us why the organization you are nominating should receive 50 free chicken sandwiches from WOCA and Chick-fil-A at the Paddock Mall. We'll review your nominations and then select one deserving organization each month. We'll announce the winner and even read the winning entry on the air. Make sure to include the contact name and phone number of the organization that you are nominating. And thanks from your friends at WOCA and Chick-fil-A in the Paddock Mall.
Back in the restaurant food show, there are some things going on you need to know about, including a chance to win $50 in gift certificates to Mark's Prime Steakhouse and Seafood. But first, there's some things happening at the restaurant that Cindy wants to talk about.
We have right now running to December 31st our gift card promotion. Once in a lifetime, once every year we do it. Buy 100, get 25 free.
100 cards, but 100.
100. Well, you can buy 100 cards.
You can buy 100
Cindy,
and still
that's
get
two,
25
that's
free.
Two, too.
There
yeah,
you go.
I'll take that too. It's 100.
How in the world do you do that, making money? So I want. I mean, wow.
You know, that's why it's only 1 month a year.
Wow.
But the key is you can stack them. You can buy 250s to get the 100 and get the 25 free. You can stack all the 25s free as you
right.
want them and give that as a prize. There's all kinds of way. And ours never expire. That's a big thing to realize.
That's a big thing. I had more cards expire on me like that day.
Yep.
I had my wallet. Oops, this is no good anymore.
You know what? And there is several restaurants, I won't name names,
yeah.
that do expire those complimentary ones within 60 to 90 days of
yeah.
purchase.
Yeah.
We do not.
Wow.
I don't care when you use them. I'm just thrilled that you're purchasing and coming back to
yeah,
Mark's.
I agree.
Nice. So you can buy those on site right there.
Online.
Online, too.
Online. We're selling them out that way as well. And you're still getting your 25 free, as well as the restaurant every day. At 2 p.m., there's a hostess on the porch selling them as any staff member in the building.
Again, the website is?
MarksPrimeSteakhouse.com.
All right. Dave, you got something you want to talk about?
Yeah, I got a couple things. First of all, this weekend, Pro Beach Volleyball, Saturday and Sunday. It's going to be a great time. We got live band, music, all kinds of stuff. But the big thing is today. Today is Veterans Day. We're giving away to any veteran who comes in, has his papers, whether he's active or retired military, a free dinner up to $15.99. All you can do is get buy a beverage.
Really?
Just that's buy awesome.
That's yeah. cool.
We've been doing it all day long, and we've had a tremendous response today, and I've met a lot of nice new people that coming in, and we're real excited about it. We just wanted to give back a little bit.
Once again, for those who didn't hear the show earlier, that we talked about how much we appreciate our veterans and the fact that Cindy said sometimes she'll see somebody in uniform and walk over and pick up their tab and say thank you. Dave had a prayer breakfast this morning. You got the Spectra going. This is on what night is this, by the way?
This is today.
Well, because today, all day. Remember, this show airs Friday. So people come down here.
What is today? Today's Tuesday, the 11th.
Today's
right?
Tuesday, yeah.
This is only good on Tuesday,
okay,
the 11th.
There you go. People walk in and say, where's my Veterans Center?
Yes. Wait a minute. I've been thinking about that.
Yeah, it repeats on Friday.
I've been up since 4. Come on, cut me some slack here.
There you go. Okay, I got a quick little question before we get into our trivia. This is kind of our fun question of the day. What, if any, celebrity chef do you follow? And I'll say, which one would you like to prepare a meal for? Now, I know you all got your celebrity chefs. Dave, you start yours.
I've cooked for Paul and John Foltz and these guys. I'm sorry. You know what? I'm still going to stick with Selma Hayek. I'm holding out for Selma Hayek.
Now, you're somebody in the food business.
In the food business.
So, chef. Now,
I tell you what though, I've never worked with Emeril, and I respect him.
And he's an icon.
And I respect what he stands for.
Boom.
I respect. That's the guy. Yeah, but that's the guy. I think that if I had to pick one person right now, one food guy, it'd be him that I'd like to cook for.
Interesting. I don't think Cindy's got one.
I do. You're gonna crack up.
Is it the guy who runs the donut place? No, I'm just kidding.
I am all about that Diners, Drive-Ins.
Really?
I am.
Really?
You know what? I love a good hidden place restaurant.
That's the dude with the spiked hair, gray hair. What's his name, God. Johnny? Look it up.
Guy Fieri.
Yes. Yeah. He just is unique enough. He gets into these places that you would never think of going. And usually when I'm traveling out of town, I look up where he's going to see if he's been at one of the restaurants in the town I'm at. And he's done a survey on him, so then I go to that restaurant.
Really?
I just think he's unique enough, his talent, his food, what he comes up with, and how he critiques the restaurants. I like that he's all over the board. Those diners, those drive-ins, I think it's kind of cool.
That's amazing. You know, you never cease to amaze me. Krispy Kreme is the restaurant you want in town, and now the drive-in and the diners is where you
want. It's amazing the food that comes out some of those places.
I'm sure there's some great food in diners. I love some diner food. Really, really good stuff.
Unique and great.
Do you guys watch Anthony Bourdain at all?
I do.
I do too.
Wow, that's a wild show.
That is crazy.
I mean,
I do
like
have to close my eyes sometimes.
I mean, I can't eat. I mean,
or
really.
I have to go to the commercial and change and come back when he's finished.
I mean, look.
That dissection.
There's
got
to be a line you draw to sound something, right? I mean, I'm just not going to eat certain foods, period. I don't care what it may be. But is it? He's unintimidated. He goes right in there, man. He wades in and he eats whatever they put in front of his face.
A very talented chef, too. On his own right.
It really is.
He's an extremely talented chef. I take my hat off to that gentleman, too.
Nope. And you notice a lot of chef shows are back. They seem to be like the newest trend.
Boy, are they ever.
A lot of Guy Harvey's got the grocery games.
Mm-hmm. Yeah.
You've got Chop. You've got so many new programs out there with chefs involved in them that I like it. I think it's nice to see a new generation kind of catching on and watching the shows and learning how to cook.
I was home today, and both my son and daughter are watching some food show. My son really loves it, and he's a kind of a TV guy. He one time thought about starting a food show. My goal on this show is so one day when we keep getting bigger and bigger is to have a little some kind of food display up here. Maybe we can't cook it in here while it'd be legal, but serve some food and show people what it looks like on our little camera up there. We're working on it. We'll get there at some point in time.
I like that.
All right. It's time to put the trivia question out there for somebody to win a $50 gift certificate to Mark's Prime Steakhouse and Seafood. And Cindy's got one for you on her website. Look it up and you can earn 50. It's very simple. You can pick it up tomorrow if you like. 50 bucks toward a great meal, or you can get a whole meal for 50 bucks at Mark's Prime Steakhouse and Seafood downtown. Cindy, what you got for us?
What is the most expensive wine that Mark's Steakhouse carries? It is on my web.
It is on your website?
Yep.
The most expensive wine.
Yes.
Can I give them a range? Is it under 5,000?
It's under 5,000.
Okay.
And we do have it in stock.
And you do have it in stock.
We do have it in stock.
Wow.
It's just not sitting out there.
Have there been nights where you've had people come in and order this outrageously expensive wine by the just?
Yeah. We have. Unbelievable. Shocking.
Yeah.
They can spend that kind of money on a bottle of wine, and the tip matched the bottle of wine price.
Really?
Later. Yes.
Are you kidding me?
I'm not. And we've sold it three times now. Three times in 2 years.
Goodness.
We bought the Fountain Blue for this wine. So,
how big is your wine cellar?
Wine cellar downstairs, it holds almost 1,000 bottles right
really?
Now. We house quite a lot of inventory
of
the rotation of keeping up with all those wines.
And so who keeps up with it?
Me and the managers. It has its days.
So you know what's down there, huh?
Yes, I do. You see me downtown in my track shoes.
Which I do sometimes.
You know, it's inventory day and I'm down in the storeroom.
I often do see you down there. That'd be fun to go down there and just see it sometime.
Yeah, you know what? We should.
Yeah,
down in the dungeon, but it's laid out.
Do you have any dust on it yet? Because you got to have a little dust or it's not really a wine cellar.
There's plenty of dust.
Okay.
There's plenty of dust on some of those boxes.
For sure. For sure. Okay, so give me your celebrities again. You want to cook for the guy. What's that guy's name again, Dave? You said
Guy Fieri?
Yes.
Guy Fieri.
Yeah.
And you can't have Selma Hayek, so you're going to go Emeril Lagasse,
so I'll go
right?
Emeril Lagasse, yeah.
So what would you cook for Emeril, by the way?
You know what? I'd go right at him with one of the dishes that I have there at the restaurant. You know, maybe the bronze redfish with the tasso cream sauce.
That's a good one.
Great dish.
And Emerald's got a new show. He's got a new food cooking show that you cook for him, you get to be one of the selected people, and then your item recipe is put on, whether it's Denny's, Outback. He lists several chain restaurants, and your menu and recipe will go on that restaurant's menu the next day.
Hmm.
It's on TV. I watch it each week. Yeah. Just to see what they're trending and what he's doing. But I do love Emerald's an icon in itself.
He is. He's a great guy. And I mean, he's
great personality, great chef, you know.
And he stands for the right things in the industry.
Exactly.
I back him up for that.
You know, you don't think about integrity sometimes, but it's an important thing for a chef,
one.
Isn't it?
Absolutely.
Huge. You know what? I'm a really big believer that the chefs, the kitchen staff are underrated. They are feeding mass public. And they have to be so on point of temperatures, keeping things iced properly, handling the food with gloves, all the detail that goes in effect to running a kitchen.
Absolutely.
And sometimes we underrate what has to go back there and how much they are in charge of a mass production.
Absolutely. It's a big undertaking, and you have to be professional. You know, I mean, and there's a lot to it. There's
so
things
much involved.
That people don't never think about.
Yep.
So many things that people don't think about, and the lay people and just in the general public.
Yep. It really must
really infuriate you to know when somebody's operating a restaurant where they're not doing that and you know about it.
Oh, I'll be honest. I'm the first to call you out. I find it just atrocious when they came out years ago where the health inspections would get advertised in the newspaper or you could see them on Channel 2 TV, who got busted for slime in the ice machines.
Yep.
I would cringe, but in the same thought, I'd go, oh my God, thank God that's not me. And I'd run back and make sure that all my areas were detailed.
Mm-hmm.
But there is a lot of people who just think of it as cash money coming through. And they cut corners. But you're dealing with the public. I'm feeding children to elderly to everyone. Utmost, I have to have care, and my team in the kitchen has to have care of what we're doing.
That's the integrity Dave talks about. It's so important.
Really important.
That's right.
All right, time for the giveaway. Again, what's the most expensive wine on Mark's Prime Steakhouse and Seafood menu? What is it? You just have to call us up now at 622-9622. Look on the website, marksprimesteakhouse.com, and you can get the price. Call us right now. And if we don't have the exact amount, I guess we'll give the closest. The person who's the closest. If it's Lisa's, all right? It's under 5,000 and over 150. How's that sound?
There you go.
Okay? So again, 622-9622 for a chance to win these wonderful certificates to Mark's Prime Steakhouse and Seafood. And we'll be waiting for your telephone call at 622-9622. If you're traveling from out of town down I-75 and you hear this program and your area code is different, it's a 352-622-9622. Give us a call. We'll give you some great food. We'll take a break. Return to the Restaurant and Food Show with Cindy Nicholson and Dave Del Rio right here on the Voice of Ocala, 1370 AM, 96.3 FM, WOCA, The Source.
My name is Bo Briggs. I'm a sixth-generation Ocalan, and I practice law with my father at the Briggs Law Firm. Over the years, we've seen many changes to Ocala and many changes in our profession. What has not changed is our commitment to our clients. You will speak with and get to know your attorney. That will never change. A lawyer will personally handle your case, not a paralegal. So if you've been injured in an accident and would appreciate personal attention, you can reach us at 671-4600 or learn more at thebriggslawfirm.com.
Guy Harvey Checking is now exclusively available at Gateway Bank. With Guy Harvey Checking, you will receive Gateway's premium checking account, plus several other Guy Harvey Ocean Foundation features, including membership to the Guy Harvey Hammerhead Nation, free Guy Harvey t-shirt, and an exclusive Guy Harvey debit card. At Gateway Bank, we will make a $50 donation to the Guy Harvey Ocean Foundation for every new account opened. This is just one more reason why people choose Gateway Bank. Sign up today for your exclusive Guy Harvey Checking account with Gateway. Details available at gatewaybankcfl.com. Member FDIC.
Hello, I'm Tom Schmitz, here to tell you about OCUS, a great resource for any business and a proud partner of the CEP. OCUS offers your business radically new technology called next-generation websites. Sites that do not wear out, they automatically adapt to new technology like smartphones, tablets, and the next big thing. Why pay for technology that starts becoming obsolete the moment you buy it? With OCUS, there is so much more. Built into the OCUS platform is an unmatched array of business solutions adaptable to any business. OCUS is a superb example that cutting-edge technology can grow and prosper in Marion County. And I should know because they handle my website, ktforfun.com. OCUS has assisted numerous companies in Marion County that have succeeded online. You can learn more by visiting them online at OCUS.com. That's OCOOS.com. Or drop by their downtown Ocala location at 116 South Magnolia Avenue. Find out how OCUS can provide your business with everything you need to succeed online.
Hi, this is JP from Penn Flooring here in Ocala. I would like to invite you to come in and visit our spacious showroom where we have solutions for every style and budget. From wall-to-wall carpet to hardwood floors and tiles, we have an unsurpassed selection of flooring. At Penn Flooring, we've provided quality customer service with a family touch for over 25 years. Visit our website at pennflooring.com or come by our showroom, 1201 Southwest 17th Street, just over the bridge. Penn Flooring, quality customer service with a family touch.
On the next AM Ocala Live, Robin and I will be speaking to Dr. William Reed. He's one of the first successful heart surgeons in America, and he's written a book. It's called The Pulse of Hope.
News Bites, the hottest news and current events are bite-sized.
And then Dr. Gloria J. Walther is coming on. She's got a book called Eye to Eye, the handbook on lovingly and successfully parenting your 3 to 5-year-old child.
Lori Arnold is a multifaceted vocalist. She performed for Pope Benedict. She'll be on the air with John Leshak, and they'll be speaking about her concert on November the 16th.
And then representatives from the education community in Ocala and Marion County will be speaking about the salute to veterans.
Have all of your legal questions answered by attorney John Fuller on Legally Yours.
And then Paul Smith will be on. His book is called Parenting with a Story.
Sharon Nice is the president and CEO of the National Waste and Recycling Association. What becomes of the trash we throw away?
All of that plus fun with Joe on the next AM Ocala Live right here on the Source WOCA 96.3 FM.
1370 AM.
Here's what you may have missed on the John Tesh Radio Show.
The apple peels, they contain a compound called ursolic acid that increases our metabolism, which means an apple a day can definitely help keep the pounds away. Models and doctors do date, but the person you meet online claiming to be one probably is not. It's the most common internet lie. Fashion experts believe the fragrance oil trend is here to stay because sales of traditional spray-on perfumes are disappearing into thin air.
Intelligence for your life on the John Tesh Radio Show. Don't miss this stuff.
Back on the Restaurant Food Show, and we used to talk about trends here. Whatever happened to the cupcake trend? That was hot for a while. Is that still around for, like, desserts and whatever?
Still around? I see it at some weddings, and there's still a lot of weddings that are doing cupcakes and stuff like that.
Publix is even doing the oversized individual cupcake
now. You know what? I made a Krispy Kreme wedding cake for a wedding.
You did?
I sure did.
Way to go.
A Krispy Kreme wedding cake?
Yes. I committed to doing it and then said, okay, now I got to figure out how to do this.
Well, how did you do it?
Yeah. Well, I used the stands and then I started practicing and how to stack them and
actual Krispy Kreme donuts.
Yes. I've got pictures on my Facebook and all. Yeah.
Oh, how fun.
Guess what she's going to want next for her birthday? What's your birthday, Cindy?
August. Okay, we'll go for Danielle's in January. We'll be calling out in January for a Krispy Kreme birthday cake. Yum.
And we'll go down to Eaton's Beach and eat it.
We'll just decorate those candles on that donut.
That's cool. Awesome. Now, that's what I call innovation.
See
there.
That?
You know?
Yeah. That's
cool.
The spirit.
Any other cool innovations you can think of people have done things? Does anybody cook wild game here? I mean, I know a lot of people like venison and stuff, but Dave, you've had some experience in that regard. I know you don't
absolutely
do it, Cindy, but I mean, I do. Quail? You do quail?
I do quail. I do duck. There is a mass amount of hunters here in Marin County.
I know, there are. Mm-hmm. Yeah.
And I do get, Mr. Cone, I get some of them that do bring their catches back, their kills, however you want to put it, and bring them in.
Yeah.
And we do make special game dinner nights for them.
Yeah.
Privately.
Well, of course, fresh fish is great if you can take them in. You know, when you've just caught them and have them cooked, they're even better at that time.
There's nothing like it. Fresh trout by the stream, over a fire.
Oh, yeah.
That's the best.
Good stuff.
Absolutely.
Yeah, absolutely. So, also, it says sriracha was a trend for a while. Is that the hot sauce? What is that?
Yeah, sriracha is a hot sauce. And you can actually do different things with it. You know, just make a simple sriracha mayonnaise. Just mix it with mayonnaise to tone it down, and you can dip, you know, fried vegetables and stuff in it. It's real simple. It's really good.
But he's right. It was a huge thing for a while.
Yes.
Like chipotle. Chipotle was huge.
Yes.
Everything had to have chipotle in it, and then it kind of tapered back down again. I don't think anything's replaced either one of those recently of the new ingredient.
And pretzel buns. It also was hot for a while. I noticed that. Was it Wendy's making the pretzel buns?
They
I never
are,
had
yes.
them.
Well, Wendy's has a burger on a pretzel bun.
I
broke down to try it.
Did you try it? How was it?
I didn't. I haven't broke down to the Wendy's.
Oh, you haven't done it yet. Okay.
But I did buy one from Publix. It was very dense.
Okay.
It was too dense to be a burger bun, I think.
Yeah, I'm thinking a little. It's still hard to get through that for your
first
sandwich.
I tried the pretzel pizza.
Oh, did you try the pretzel
pizza? Yeah, I tried the pretzel pizza. It's hard to say. You know, it was okay. I wouldn't be opposed to getting it again.
Really? Oh, okay.
Yeah, it was okay.
I'll have to wait for Danielle to get home to do one of those.
Yeah, it was all right. Yeah.
My vote for the least original idea, and I'm not going to name the company, is people putting Fritos on pizza.
Oh, that's terrible. That doesn't even look good. That doesn't even look good. I saw that, and that did not even...
It's too.
Nothing wrong with a good Frito.
It's not something I would do. It's too big.
Hey, really? But for another $5, you can get a chocolate chip cookie pizza to go with it.
That just doesn't. You took away from.
Speaking of which, we got time. We got to give our winner out. Who is it? Dan.
Dan Greer.
Dan Greer is the winner of the $50 gift certificate. We'll expect, of course, to be invited by Dan when we go down there. That's just how this works, right? Mark's Prime Steakhouse and Seafood. And Cindy Nicholson, thank you, Cindy, for making it possible to give that away. And Dave, of course, we gave away some of his certificates a couple of weeks ago. We'll have more. So coming up next week. So
what was the answer, though? Dan won, but what was the answer?
The answer was, what's the most expensive?
Screaming Eagle.
Screaming Eagle. How much is it?
$2,100 on my website.
Now, what are you screaming?
Yes.
$2,100 a bottle.
Very allocated wine. Very
you
difficult
sell that?
To get. We do. We do. It's our second allocation of it. Last year, I fought the Fountain Blue for it. There's only 6 in the state of Florida, and we got 3, breaking half of them to get 3. And this year, we did the same thing.
I remember you said you talked about going down to get that.
Yeah.
You went head-to-head with the Fountain Blue.
The Fountain Blue. Little Marion County stood their ground.
As a girl who grew up down there in South Florida, the Fountain Blue at one time was the Mac Daddy of places.
It still is. Some things are icons.
All the days the Rat Pack used to play there and stuff. We're out of time, folks. It's been fun. And, of course, if you listen to the show on Tuesday, the offer's not the same on Friday.
That's okay. Right.
Don't bother trying to call up and answer the question. On behalf of Dave Del Rio and Cindy Nicholson, Restaurant and Food Show, I'm Buddy Martin. Stay tuned. Coming up next is Buddy Martin Sports Page right here on
1370 AM, 96.3 FM, WOCA, The Source.
Requires bank approval. Vehicle purchase price fixed rate allowance.
Fumble.
I was so busy making my fantasy football picks that I forgot to stock up on inventory, and now I need cars fast, so I'm calling for an inventory blitz. Chris Spears here from Prestige Auto Sales. This month, bring me in your old car, and you could score the nicer newer ride you've been fantasizing about for just $10 down.
Sack your old car.
And start driving the nicer newer car of your dreams for just $10 down. Don't get fouled by past credit problems.
All
car for the People Credit Approval Process is the game changer you've been waiting for.
We huddle up the banks and lenders to help you get approved and back in the game. So stop driving a car you hate.
Punt it and drive a nicer, newer car for just $10 down today.
I'm throwing in a Hail Mary to make my month, and I need your help. Trade in your old car, and you could drive for just $10 down. But don't wait till the clock runs out. This deal is over when my inventory is full. I'm Chris Spears, and I'm a dealer for the people.
Visit us at Prestige Auto Sales or call 694-1234. Yes, 694-1234. See you at Prestige.
Does osteoarthritis bring frustration with every step? Do pain and stiffness affect your everyday activities? If so, you may be interested in a research study for the treatment of pain associated with osteoarthritis. RentStar Medical Research is conducting a research study of an investigational medication for individuals between the ages of 40 and 75 and who have been treated for the pain associated with osteoarthritis for at least 3 months. Qualified participants will receive study-related medical care and investigational medication. Compensation for time and travel will be provided. To learn more about this osteoarthritis study, please call RentStar Medical Research in Ocala at 352-629-5800. Again, that's 352-629-5800. Imagine yourself in a quaint bistro right in the heart of a charming French village about to indulge in real French cuisine. Located in beautiful, vibrant downtown Ocala, La Cuisine offers authentic French cuisine and wine from an award-winning menu. Patrice and Elodie moved to Ocala in 2009 because they fell in love with it. And you're going to fall in love with La Cuisine if you haven't already. La Cuisine offers a quick bite for lunch or a leisurely dinner in a comfortable and relaxed setting. So call La Cuisine of Ocala today at 352-433-2570. It's like a direct call to Paris.
Hi, Danny Werfel here. Get moving with Florida Credit Union's fast and easy loan approval process.
Let Florida Credit Union start up a new car loan for you today. No more waiting, hassles, or stop signs. You can even apply online. With a strong financial team behind you, you can enjoy great rates and fast approvals.
It's all about personalized service and a streamlined process.
Florida Credit Union, connecting your money to your life.
I'm Major George Patterson from the Salvation Army. Please stop by our family store at 120 Northwest 10th Street in Ocala, where on Wednesday you have a 50% off clothing and bric-a-brac. On Friday, 25% off furniture and large appliances. And on Saturday, stop by to our yard sale from 8:45 to 11. Donations can be made by calling 352-732-4469 and we'll pick it up. Funds from the store go toward the services that we provide in Marion County.
Hello, I'm Tom Schmitz, here to tell you about Ocus, a great resource for any business and a proud partner of the CEP. Ocus offers your business radically new technology called next-generation websites. Sites that do not wear out, they automatically adapt to new technology like smartphones, tablets, and the next big thing. Why pay for technology that starts becoming obsolete the moment you buy it? With Ocus, there is so much more. Built into the Ocus platform is an unmatched array of business solutions adaptable to any business. Ocus is a superb example that cutting-edge technology can grow and prosper in Marion County. And I should know because they handle my website, ktforfun.com. Ocus has assisted numerous companies in Marion County that have succeeded online. You can learn more by visiting them online at ocus.com. That's OCOOS.com. Or drop by their downtown Ocala location at 116 South Magnolia Avenue. Find out how Ocus can provide your business with everything you need to succeed online.
News Talk 1370. WOCA invites you to discover your full business potential. News Talk Radio is the perfect environment for your advertising. WOCA's News Talk format pinpoints information hungry, better educated, high income adults. So use us to talk to them. Call 732-8000. 732-8000. We're Ocala News Talk Radio. News Talk 1370. WOCA.
Broadcasting from the Paddock Mall Studios, this is WOCA, Ocala, Gainesville, The Villages, 1370 AM, 96.3 FM, The Source.
Fox News Radio, I'm Jane Metzler.
The world
is watching.
Missouri Governor Jay Nixon outlining a security plan ahead of a grand jury's decision in the fatal August shooting of teen Michael Brown Jr.
Officers from the Missouri State Highway Patrol, St. Louis County Police, and St. Louis City Police will operate as a unified command to protect the public. The National Guard has been and will continue to be part of our contingency planning.
A decision on whether to indict Ferguson police officer Darren Wilson expected by the end of the month. Alleging misconduct by police and prosecutors, lawyers for Jodi Arias say her conviction for killing her boyfriend should be tossed.
They say thousands of pornographic images were deleted from Travis Alexander's computer while that computer was in police custody.
Fox Radio's Jessica Rosenthal, the Dow and S&P closing up a point, the NASDAQ up nine. Fox News, we report, you decide.
Okay, the Atlanta trip. I have the rental car receipt, but no proof that I actually flew there. I have two breakfast receipts, but no dinners, and apparently I slept in the lobby because I have nothing from the hotel.
Traveling for work is work enough. Concur makes it easy. Your business travelers take pictures of receipts and submit expense reports from their smartphones. With Concur, they get to throw away the receipts, you get to rule the budget, and everyone goes home happy. Test drive it free at tryconcur.com.
Dentist office, may I help you?
Hi, I'd like to cancel my teeth whitening appointment.
May I ask why?
I found a teeth whitener that works in 5 minutes that I can do from home. It's called Power Swabs.
Hi, I'm John Greenhut, and if you want to whiten your teeth 2 shades in 5 minutes and 6 shades in 7 days, then try Power Swabs. Just swab your teeth and you're done. Try Power Swabs risk-free by calling 1-800-663-5922. That's 1-800-663-5922. 1-800-663-5922.
How much time? 30? 30 seconds? I'm on right now. I don't believe you.
Okay, okay. Enough kidding around.
Ho, 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 ho.
And now it's time for the
Buddy Martin Sports Page.
He actually had me stay here last night in his gym.
It's like I don't fit in. It's like I don't belong here.
Let's go talk to a couple of guys that never gamble.
Oh, see, I made Lewis a bet here. Lewis bet me that we couldn't both get rich and put you on the poorhouse at the same time. He didn't think we could do it.
Gambling is illegal at Bushwood, sir, and I never slice.
And now,
here's Buddy.
Funny, I'm not hearing anything. I guess we're on. Hopefully. Okay, it says I'm on the air. We'll see. Let it end. Give it a shot. Anyway, this is the Tuesday edition of the Voice of Ocala. Buddy Martin Sports Page. Now I can hear it. Thank you very much. Today on the program, we got special guests from up in South Carolina, the Columbia State reporter who covers South Carolina football. Mr. Cloninger will be joining us soon. He's the beat guy for the state, and it's an interesting week up in South Carolina. Coach Steve Spurrier apologizing earlier this week about not showing up, or showing up, but 54 seconds after the loss a couple weeks ago, and saying he should have done it. Of course, this is South Carolina, Florida week, and there's a lot going on there with the situation with the guy who was considered a lame duck coach at one time, Will Muschamp, and, of course, the former Florida coach, who naturally is beloved by many still here in the state of Florida, who brought the Gators their first national championship in 1996. I got reports today on a couple of things you might find interesting, which I'll share with you. One of them is about the pressure that Steve Spurrier is under right now and how concerned he is about what's going on with his program. And also what may come as a bit of a surprise about the future of Will Muschamp, which comes to me from a very good source. However, nothing official, just saying, a very good source. And we'll keep you posted on that as well. We'll touch upon the national picture and the situation with the playoff committee. We talked about it some with Joe Williams of Mile High Sports yesterday, how this Saturday, heavyweight fights, we call them, the elimination games, three of them played last week, are becoming so popular and so dramatic, how they've gone beyond anything we could ever expect. And John Cooper is the managing editor of Saturday Down South, a very good football site. If you haven't gone onto it, college football, you want to check that out. John Cooper will be with us in the second half hour here to talk about the national picture. We'll touch on a couple other things. Apparently, the folks out in Baton Rouge are apologizing for what they said to Nick Saban, a profane chant that took place at Saban. We'll discuss that a little bit later on. And then we'll maybe take a look at the Heisman situation. We haven't talked about the Heisman. It's changed so much. It seems like it changes from day to day, week to week, and we'll see who's in the hunt there. So there's a few things to talk about today on the program. Hope you'll stay tuned for all that. Right now, here's Tom with the headlines.
Buddy, I got to turn my mic up. Can you hear me now?
Yeah, I can hear you.
The Denver Broncos, who have had sort of a musical chairs at offensive line over the last couple weeks, have brought in Richie Incognito for a workout and are mulling the possibility of signing him. Their run game has stagnated, they said, and they're experimenting with combinations up front, and it's possible the Broncos believe things have cooled down enough with Incognito and they are considering signing Richie Incognito. Would you consider signing him, buddy?
I wouldn't. But, I mean, on the other hand, I don't know the whole story. He was involved in a hazing situation. He used some bad words. Supposedly ran a kid out of football who was an African-American. Do I know the whole story? No. Based on what I know right now, I wouldn't sign the guy. But on the other hand, if a guy can help you win, people don't care really too much about what his background is.
Speaking of people don't care, if as long as you win, Mark Sanchez did his part for the Eagles while the defense dominated, special teams shined. Darren Sproles had two touchdowns. Mark Sanchez threw for two scores. And the defense of the Philadelphia Eagles sacked Cam Newton of the Carolina Panthers nine times on way to a 45-21 route in Monday Night Football. Sanchez, filling in for an injured Nick Foles, had 332 yards passing in his first start since December 30th of 2012. I've always said if you give Mark Sanchez the tools to throw to and the time to do so, he's not that bad a quarterback.
He's a coach killer. He'll just get you to break your heart. Get you up there to a point, get you near, and next thing you know, he'll have a choke game. So don't get your hopes up, Eagle fans. You saw a pretty good Mark Sanchez the last three quarters, but invariably, when it counts, he can't get the job done.
San Francisco 49ers linebacker Patrick Willis missed the remainder of the season and required surgery for a strained muscle in his left big toe. Willis was placed on the season-ending injury reserve list Tuesday for the injury suffered in the third quarter against St. Louis. A Pro Bowler all seven seasons in the NFL, Willis has missed six games in his career before this setback with his toe. And, buddy, trust me when I tell you, people laugh. Oh, he's on the injury reserve. He can't play because of a big toe. Yes, I promise you, when you tear the tendons in your big toe, being that that's your balance appendage on your foot and everything, it's a huge deal.
Ever tried to play a football game with a broken toe?
No.
I have.
Not
fun. It's one of the worst pains I've ever been through in my life.
And finally, the NFL's Players Association has filed an expedited grievance with the NCAA to reinstate Minnesota Vikings running back Adrian Peterson. The NFLPA cited Monday explicit language in a signed agreement from September 28th when Peterson was placed on the special commissioner's exempt list following his indictment on felony child abuse charges. He pled no contest Thursday to a misdemeanor reckless assault, freeing him from the court system, provided he fulfills his terms of probation. The league began a review Thursday of his case under the personal conduct policy, but it said Peterson will remain on paid leave until that process is completed. The union has demanded in a letter that the NFL reinstate Peterson immediately per the agreement that was signed September 18th.
Aren't you just a little bit tired of all this? I mean, look, the Ray McDonald thing played out. As it turned out, there wasn't any evidence there. And the court of public opinion weighs in on these things. And sometimes, in the case of Ray Rice, it wasn't loud enough. In the case of McDonald, I think he got railroaded, to be honest with you, in this situation. Turns out there wasn't enough evidence there. But it seems like now, every week, there's another case of some kind of domestic violence. Yes, we know that that alcohol and testosterone and drugs and violent men don't mix well. We understand that domestic abuse is a problem. We get that. But it seems like every week there's another story about that.
Well, the NFL changed their mind on how it wants to deal with it.
They have a policy.
It says September 18th that you were on this exempt list until this was ran through the court system. Yeah. It's ran through the court system now. You got to reinstate him. Now you can't come up with another reason to keep him on the exempt list.
If this is a criminal case, they throw it out of court.
Right.
Also, do you get a little sometimes sick of fans who want to just use profane language to chant it? I mean, you know, it's not.
I'm tired of that.
People are getting tired of it. In fact, LSU had to apologize for it today. We'll tell you about that, some of the things they chanted at Nick Saban. By the way, Nick Saban taking a little shot at Tim Tebow when compared to Dak Prescott. Tell you about that, too. All that coming up right here. Stay tuned for David Cloninger of the Columbia State. We're talking about South Carolina and Florida coming up Saturday at the Swamp. We'll take a timeout. Return after this on
1370 AM, 96.3 FM. We're live and local on The Source. The Marion County Seminole Club, Inc., a proud sponsor of FSU football here on The Source. For more information, contact the Marion County Seminole Club at marionseminoles.org or email them at marionseminoleclub@gmail.com.
If you've been hearing about the crowded Eaton's Beach Sandbar and Grill and were worried because you couldn't get in, I've got some good news for you. Seating is now available. While you're there, look up Chef Dave Del Rio. He'll buy you a drink. Now is the time for you to finally see firsthand what your friends are talking about at Eaton's Beach Sandbar and Grill. Try Chef Dave's tantalizing Floresiana menu. Check out those gorgeous Legware sunsets. Eaton's Beach Sandbar and Grill on beautiful Legware. Seating now available.
Mayhem is everywhere.
I'm the football your buddy fired through your windshield. The cooler that tumbled out of a pickup and onto the hood of your car. If you're a football fan, eventually we're gonna meet. So get Allstate, where agents help keep you protected from mayhem. Like me.
Are you in good hands?
Hey, this is Kevin McDonald, your local Allstate agent. Call me at 622-2333, and let's make sure you're in good hands.
Guy Harvey Checking is now exclusively available at Gateway Bank. With Guy Harvey Checking, you will receive Gateway's premium checking account plus several other Guy Harvey Ocean Foundation features, including membership to the Guy Harvey Hammerhead Nation, free Guy Harvey t-shirt, and an exclusive Guy Harvey debit card. At Gateway Bank, we will make a $50 donation to the Guy Harvey Ocean Foundation for every new account opened. This is just one more reason why people choose Gateway Bank. Sign up today for your exclusive Guy Harvey Checking account with Gateway. Details available at gatewaybankcfl.com. Member FDIC.
Hi, this is Randy Briggs of the Briggs Law Firm. Traditional help for truly injured. We trademark registered this belief years ago as our description of our practice at the Briggs Law Firm. By traditional help, we mean that clients actually meet with a partner in the firm who will personally handle their case, not a paralegal. Well, what about truly injured? We limit our practice to injury claims having merit with clients who indeed have been injured. So if you or a loved one have been truly injured, compare our credentials at the Briggs Law Firm.com or call us at 671-4600.
Visit the WOCA website at www.wOCA.com.
WOCA.
Whether you're building it up or knocking it down, get it done, rent it now. Sunbelt Rentals is here to make your job a little easier. Our knowledgeable staff will help you find the right equipment for any job, big or small. Did you know that Sunbelt Rentals carries heaters, air conditioners, generators, lighting, traffic control, and so much more? So whether you're building it up or knocking it down, we've got the equipment you need. Get it done, rent it now. And right now, for a limited time, you can have it for less. Just by mentioning this ad, if you rent it Friday afternoon, you can keep it the whole weekend and only pay for one day. But this is a limited time offer, so stop into Sunbelt Rentals today, Northwest 27th, just a quarter mile east of I-75. For more information, just give us a call, 352-369-9101. 352-369-9101. Sunbelt Rentals. Get it done, rent it now. 352-369-9101. 352-369-9101.
Hey, it's Christy with Ocala Mac and PC Repair and Ocala Guest Wi-Fi to let you know we have you covered. We are the only local certified Apple and Microsoft computer company in Ocala. We are family owned and operated. From mobile repair to wireless networks, viruses, new systems, or security cameras, we do it all. Check us out online, ocalamacpc.com, or give us a call, 352-566-8324.
Tell them Nick, Madison, or Mason sent you and get free diagnostic.
Get your internet telephone service from the company that brought affordable internet service to Ocala in the first place. All It Save is a sister company of Ocala Guest Wi-Fi, a company you've known and trusted for all your internet needs. Whether you need a phone or hundreds, we've got the products and services to meet your needs both now and in the future. Our plans include everything from local and long-distance calling to equipment maintenance and even software upgrades. You can count on All It Save to give you cost certainty knowing that your bill will be the same next week, next month, or even next year. Call 352-450-8647 today to learn how to cut your monthly telephone bill up to 60%.
On Saturday, the South Carolina Gamecocks come in here somewhat limping. Potential for Steve Spurrier to have a losing season. This is a pivotal game for the Gamecocks. Florida, on the upside, now has won a couple. Looks like Will Muschamp may be saving his job. The Gators are 5-3, and Steve Spurrier faces his alma mater in the Swamp. We all want to know which South Carolina team is going to show up and if, in fact, they will bring a defense. With us on the phone today on our hotline to talk about that game is a guy who covers the Gamecocks on a regular basis for the state in Columbia, David Cloninger. Hi, David.
Hey, how's it going today?
Going good. The luster is somewhat gone off the South Carolina season. What do the Gamecocks have left to play for?
Well, right now it's just about trying to get bowl eligible. You know, they're 4-5. They have 3 games left, so they need to win 2 of those to get to a bowl. They know they gave one away against Tennessee, just like they did against Missouri and Kentucky, and they know that they're going to have to win one of these games on the road, either at Florida or at Clemson. So neither one of them is a very appetizing choice, but that's the bet that they've made, and they've got to sleep in it. So they're just trying to come back after a bye week and go down to the Swamp and see if they can get a win.
You know, it's not been a promising season for this team that was picked to win the SEC East and ranked in the top 10. But there are some really good football players on that team. One of the ones I really enjoy watching is Pharaoh Cooper, who I think is going to be a tremendous pro, who catches everything, he can return punch kickoffs, he gets open, he catches the ball. Give me your take on what kind of season Pharaoh Cooper's having.
Oh, just an absolutely fantastic season for the young man. I mean, they knew that he could do a lot when he came in. I mean, he was actually recruited as a defensive back. And then they saw him in one practice and said, yeah, we're not going to waste you on defense. We need you with the ball in your hands. So he can do a little bit of everything, as you saw last week. It's just unfortunate South Carolina found a way to blow that game and really rob Pharaoh Cooper of a lot of national recognition that he should have had for that great game. But they're going to try to keep getting the ball in his hands as much as possible, whether that be running Wildcat quarterback, throwing the occasional pass, just running with it or playing wide receiver. They're going to get him the ball, and he's just having a terrific season. I think he's second in SEC game receiving yards, only behind Amari Cooper. So any time you can put your name up beside that guy, you're doing something good.
The Coopers are having a good year, that's for sure. Let's talk about the defense or absence thereof. There are a few good players on defense. You just don't lose players like they lost last year, including Jadeveon Clowney, and expect to come back and be as good as they were on defense. This has been an embarrassing situation for the Gamecocks. Haven't been able to hold a 2-touchdown lead, not just once, but twice in the second half on 2 occasions. And it just seems like that the defense is just not there. What is going on there? Where in your mind has it fallen apart?
Well, actually, buddy, it's happened on 3 occasions. You know, it just shows you just how embarrassing it is in these games against Missouri, Kentucky, and Tennessee. But the main thing is, buddy, obviously they don't have the personnel that they had in years past, but they just can't do the little things right. They can't tackle. They can't wrap up, you know. I've never seen so many touchdowns be walked into the end zone as I have against South Carolina this year. It's just honestly ridiculous, because you figure that these guys would at least know how to tackle and how to play the fundamentals, but they just can't do it. And that's what's led to a big part of their problems, which it's not scheme, it's not the guys they're putting in, it's just from the first guy to the last guy, they don't know how to do the little things right.
Absolutely. Talking to David Clunger, the state that covers South Carolina football. You've covered this for a few seasons now. You're no stranger to Steve Spurrier. He's internalizing an awful lot right now. Seems like he is a very unhappy camper, to say the least. And, of course, last week it sort of reached a new low with a 54-second press conference. And I understand he apologizes this week. Can you walk us through that?
Yeah, it was just a real strange situation, buddy. Obviously, the Tennessee game was a hurtful one, but he comes in afterwards and just, you know, goes over it and really just seemed kind of shell-shocked. And then he said, I just don't think I need to take any questions. You guys all saw it. Now, obviously, that was the wrong thing to do. He did apologize for it. And, you know, said that he should have just stayed in there and answered some questions. So I honestly think that he was so stunned that this had happened again, and in just an excruciating fashion, he really didn't know how to handle it, you know. Mm-hmm. He's never had to deal with this kind of situation before. Now, they've lost games, but nothing like this three times in a row in the same season.
If you go back and look in all championship teams, they went close games. South Carolina has lost every close game except Georgia. And when you lose those close games, they also just kind of are gut-wrenching. Do you think Spurrier is undergoing the most pain you've seen him in the 10 years he's been in South Carolina?
Oh, I think so, buddy. I mean, that first year, you know, where he thought he would come in and turn it around immediately, you know, that hurt when he went down to Auburn and lost 48-7, when Alabama pinned his ears back. But it ended up getting better because they won their final five SEC games. Well, there's no magic solution for this year. It's bad. It's not going to get any better. And the fact is that, you know, a guy who has won three straight 11-win seasons, done something at Carolina that's never been done before, he doesn't have an answer for this year. So that's just tremendously galling to a guy who, as you know, has always found a way to win, even with some not very talented teams.
Dylan Thompson has had some great numbers. He's obviously a really good quarterback, but he has inconsistency. He throws picks sometimes that just kill South Carolina. Give me your assessment on Dylan Thompson's year.
Yeah, it really is a shame, buddy, because Dylan Thompson will probably go down as having the greatest passing yardage season by any South Carolina quarterback. But if they don't find a way to get to a bowl, it's going to be in the helm of a losing season. And don't get me wrong, 99% of this team's problems come from the defense because they can't stop anybody. But Dylan Thompson has made, you're right, some just really, really bad throws that really really bad times, and that's what people are pointing out to him with the criticism, because you just can't come out and throw a pick from your own end zone. You can't come out and check down from a run play in a tie game and throw a pass that gets batted up in return for an interception and a touchdown. You just can't do that, and he's had a couple of those bad plays this year. And, you know, we're never as high with the highs or low with the lows, but as this season has gone on, it's just people are ignoring the numbers he's putting up and pointing out the couple of mistakes he makes per game. Why? Because the team is not winning. And like I said, it's mostly the defense. But there's been a couple of plays where he really would have liked to have back.
No question about that. David Clunger from the state talking about this South Carolina team that has been disappointing to everybody, including the head football coach. Who's the quarterback next year?
Well, that's an interesting question, buddy. I wish I could tell you a definite answer. All they have is candidates. Right now, there's Connor Mitch and Perry Orth. They played very, very sparingly this season, and neither of them have separated themselves. They have a redshirt freshman in Michael Scarnecchia that Spurrier likes. They have a true freshman in Lorenzo Nunez coming in, who's a bit of a runner. And then you have Farrell Cooper. I mean, would you put him in and trust him to throw 20 or 30 times per game? I don't know if they would or if he would want to, but that's going to be an option just because they don't have a clear-cut backup right now. So I'll have to give you that answer at the end of spring practice.
Okay, David. Well, we'll see you up at the Swamp, and thanks for your time. Again, you can follow – what's the website for the state? I've forgotten.
It's GoGamecocks.com.
And David Clunger, he'll give you all the information you want to know about the South Carolina Gamecocks. Thanks, David. Appreciate it.
No problem, buddy. Thanks for having me.
Yeah, I mean, Steve is I talked to someone today who says he's just absolutely beside himself right now. And quite frankly, I'm told by a third party that he's really worried about getting blown out Saturday. And that would be embarrassing for anybody, but especially for one of the most revered guys in the history of the program in his own ball field.
You know what I don't understand, and this goes into this game Saturday, is Will Muschamp. He beats Georgia convincingly. He beats Vanderbilt convincingly. But he got blown out by Missouri. He's not had a good – Treon Harris, yes, looked better Saturday throwing the football. But this is a guy that even if – 7-4 seems to be this magic number. Even if he finishes 7-4, that means he beats South Carolina. He beats Eastern Kentucky, loses to Florida State. His winning percentage, he'll be 29-20. His winning percentage will be 592. That's 0.4 of a point less than Ron Zook. And somehow everybody thinks this guy's still going to keep his job and should be – and he is going to keep his job. And this guy's the future of the program. And I just still think you cut bait, buddy, and move on.
Well, you say that, but no one knows for sure if he's going to keep his job. Who knows? What if Muschamp resigns? I think he will. Here's my report on that. Someone I know very well and trust a lot said, in his opinion, and he is pretty well connected, there's no question that Will Muschamp has saved his job with a Georgia win and, of course, Vanderbilt. Now, if he loses and gets blown out by South Carolina, which I don't think will happen, he surely won't get beat by Eastern Michigan and get beat by Florida State. And that's a little different situation. That becomes a 5-6 season? Is that what that becomes?
Right.
No, it'll be a 6-5 season if they win.
Right.
Yeah, in the cupcake game. But I'm told Will Muschamp has pretty much saved his job and will be the head coach. I don't think that's a wrong decision right now, although I have said in past years, especially last year, the way things were going, that he should be fired. I think he's probably done about what he could do this year, and I think if they had somebody better, and apparently they don't, unless you think Mike Shanahan's it or something, I think probably they need to stay with him another season. It will be interesting, however, to see what happens, because there's a lot of football to be played here, and a lot of things can yet happen to the Florida program.
I just don't – it seems like 7-4, 6-6, 4-8, we've become – the University of Florida has become more like, hey, look at us, we're Arkansas, than the University of Florida.
Speaking of Arkansas, look around the league and see how many teams are losing so many games and how many will have lost 4-5 games. And when you come out in the middle of the pack, let's be honest, I'm not a huge Muschamp fan here, but he is, you know, off the top, we say he'd win 8 games. Well, one of them get canceled.
Well,
Idaho.
Yeah, it's. But so it's, if you, it's the way if you
do
he the, lost.
If you do the math, though, still 7 wins was what he would have gotten 8.
Right, you're right.
He comes out on the number. And, yeah, did he look terrible? Yeah, but how about the Georgia game? You said numerous times on this program he's got to beat
he's
Georgia.
He's got to beat Georgia.
He didn't just
you're
beat
right.
him.
And he beat him.
Dominated him.
He embarrassed him.
Okay,
you're
so
right.
That wiped away some of his sins right there. So, all right, stay tuned. John Cooper from Saturday Down South will join us next right here on Buddy Martin Sports Page.
1370 AM, 96.3 FM. We're live and local. On the Source.
When you were a kid, you had all sorts of toys. Toy cars, boats, trucks, entire toy boxes full of fun. Of course, you never really outgrow your toys, do you? It's just that now, instead of a box full, you have a garage full. Cars, trucks, boats, motorcycles, ATVs, and more. As you get older, your love of toys just gets stronger. So protect those toys the best way possible by switching to Allstate. An Allstate agent can help do the switching, paperwork, bundle all your policies together, and even find you a bunch of discounts. So if you love your toys, make sure you protect your toys by making one call to an Allstate agent.
Protect all your toys with Allstate and the McDonald Agency. Established in 1985, we have offices in Ocala and the Villages to better serve you. Give us a call at 622-2333. Subject to terms, conditions, and availability.
Are you in good hands?
Being the Culligan man is not easy because he works hard every day for you here in North Central Florida. Whether you need bottled water delivery for your office, a home water softener, or water infiltration system, the Culligan man can help you. At Culligan North Florida, we have dozens of softener and filtration options, along with a host of media tank sizes. Depending on the exact hardness and usage of your water, we determine the size of softener you're going to need. And if you're on city or well water in one of our local areas, the in-home water analysis is absolutely free. If your needs are for the home, call Ocala Water Conditioning, 352-291-5900. For home or business bottled water in Ocala, call Ocala Bottled Water, 352-291-5900. Culligan of North Florida, a proud sponsor of Florida State football, heard right here on WOCA, The Source.
Fox News Radio, I'm Jane Metzler.
The world is watching.
Missouri Governor Jay Nixon outlining a security plan ahead of a grand jury's decision in the fatal August shooting of teen Michael Brown Jr.
Officers from the Missouri State Highway Patrol, St. Louis County Police, and St. Louis City Police will operate as a unified command to protect the public. The National Guard has been and will continue to be part of our contingency planning.
A decision on whether to indict Ferguson police officer Darren Wilson expected by the end of the month. Alleging misconduct by police and prosecutors, lawyers for Jodi Arias say her conviction for killing her boyfriend should be tossed.
They say thousands of pornographic images were deleted from Travis Alexander's computer while that computer was in police custody.
Fox Radio's Jessica Rosenthal, the Dow and S&P closing up a point, the NASDAQ up 9. Fox News, we report, you decide.
Okay, the Atlanta trip. I have the rental car receipt, but no proof that I actually flew there. I have two breakfast receipts, but no dinners, and apparently I slept in the lobby because I have nothing from the hotel.
Traveling for work is work enough. Concur? You get to rule the budget, and everyone goes home happy. Test drive it free at tryconcur.com.
Dentist office, may I help you?
Hi, I'd like to cancel my teeth whitening appointment.
May I ask why?
I found a teeth whitener that works in 5 minutes that I can do from home. It's called Power Swabs.
Hi, I'm John Greenhut, and if you want to whiten your teeth 2 shades in 5 minutes and 6 shades in 7 days, then try Power Swabs. Just swab your teeth and you're done. Try Power Swabs risk-free by calling 1-800-663-5922. That's 1-800-663-5922. 1-800-663-5922.
On this episode of What Not to Do, brought to you by
Mike's Got Plumbing. If water runs through it, we do it.
Honey.
In here.
Are you tearing up the bathroom? I thought we agreed to let Mike's Got Plumbing handle this on Monday.
Yeah, I know, but I got this. I watched a how-to video on YouTube.
Oh, well. So instead of calling the professionals at Mike's Got Plumbing, who, by the way, do this for a living, and wait, is that a jackhammer?
Yep, watch this. Let the master show you how it's done. Okay, we may have an ever so slight leaking problem.
Great job, Mr. Genius. Now you broke the water line.
No. That was like that when I got here.
Well, looks like the only thing you've mastered is the art of making a mess. So now I'm picking up the phone and calling Mike Scott Plumbing, who won't charge us extra for nights, weekends, or holidays.
No, wait. I can fix this. Just hand me that.
The only thing I'm handing you is the phone. No, wait. I'll handle this. 237-2888.
On next week's episode of What Not to Do.
The fire department.
Robin, how do you like my design?
You're designing a box?
That's not a box. It's a doghouse.
Rough draft for your rough rough? Sounds like you need personal service.
I do?
Yes, to print the blueprints. See Mark at the Personal Service Center. He can print blueprints, notarize permit applications, print and mail out invoices, and even provide great-looking business cards.
Personal Service Center. That's the one on the corner of Northeast 25th Avenue and 24th Street, right?
Just look for the yellow signs. Your pedigree palace will be a reality in no time.
Stay informed on everything going on in the villages with the Village Spectator newspaper. The Village Spectator is exclusively devoted to the villages with news, commentary, and more. And yes, they have Tom's Picks, a free referral for people who are looking for a company to do work for them. Tom's Picks will refer the company that fits your needs, and all we ask is that you tell them where you heard about them. Call Tom's Picks at 804-1223 and pick up your copy of the Village Spectator today.
Now read Ocala Downtown Newspaper online.
Welcome back to Blake's Sports Page. You know, when you're looking for a website to read about football, Personally, I prefer southernpigskin.com, but there are a few, and I say a few, really good ones out there. And one of them is Saturday Down South, which is produced right here in the great state of Florida in Orlando. And the co-founder of the website and the guy who does a lot of the work is our guest, John Cooper, who joins us now on the program. Hi, John.
Hey, buddy. How's it going?
Have you figured out now how not to work 24 hours a day?
Unfortunately, during the season, it's 24-hour news cycle, so it's pretty much impossible to avoid that.
Absolutely. Can I get you to speak up a little bit? We're having a difficult time getting you. If you get a little closer to your microphone there, appreciate it. John Cooper follows the national football scene very closely, and we've said on this program a number of times, John, and you've written about a lot of this on Saturday Down South, the website, that this season has worked out, in our opinion, beyond expectations when we began with the first Final Four of college football. What is your take so far on what this season has produced?
Well, I think as far as the season overall, there's not one team that stands out in the country. And obviously Mississippi State, Florida State have the goose eggs in the loss columns. But at the same time, there's so much parity in college football that any team can beat any team on any day. And it doesn't really matter that those two teams are undefeated right now. We're looking at Saturday, one-loss Alabama against Mississippi State. Alabama could very well win that game at home, and, nobody would even call it an upset. Matter of fact, they're favored by a touchdown is what the opening line was. So I just think that there's so many good players around college football, and I think the style of play on offenses has kind of leveled the playing field from a standpoint that's created so much parity. More so than even last year or any season I can remember.
It seems like scoring in the 60s and 70s is nothing anymore, and even the teams noted for defense have found this out. The offensive explosion has taken place. I got to think there's some old-school coaches, coordinators out there who don't sleep at night.
Well, I think so, too, and we've talked about that a lot in our office and the reasons behind that. And, of course, smart head coaches, great coordinators such as Malzahn, Kevin Sumlin, have great elite offensive minds come into the league and kind of transform it. We saw that with Urban Meyer, said he'll never win a championship with a spread offense. He won it. I think at the end of the day, while there's still some good defenses, while there's some great defensive players, I think the quality of play on the defensive side of the ball has really diminished. I think the tackling has been borderline terrible. There's a lot of arm tackles. There's bad form tackling. And I don't know, whether these guys aren't being as aggressive as in the past and whether this really the targeting penalty has kind of taken away from some of the aggression these guys have.
Good point. I think you're exactly right. The targeting thing has made people a little tentative. On the other hand, sometimes these guys go for the big hit because they want to be on SportsCenter, make the big play. And sometimes just breaking down and maintaining is the part they don't seem to be able to do. I know up in South Carolina, Steve Spurrier is pulling out his gray hairs with what he's put through. He's been put through this season so far. Of course, it could be more bad news this Saturday at the Swamp when he plays a game against his old alma mater, the Florida Gators. What do you think's gone wrong up in Columbia?
I think there's a lot of issues. I think, number one, you can start with the defensive line, losing Kelsey Quarles. Jadeveon Clowney is two huge holes to fill. They had one returning starter, so they switched up their defense a little bit, went from more of a 4-3 scheme to a 3-4 because they had some quality linebackers. So I think that's the biggest issue. Second issue is they lost two really good corners last year, Jimmy DeGree, Victor Hampton. These are two guys that were – really played elite at times in the secondary and allowed the front four to have a lot of success in turn and helped the secondary. This year they're not getting as much pass rush, and the secondary is having trouble, really covering people for a long amount of time. And that's a bad combination to have. So I think, while there are some issues along the offensive line has had some problems, I think you can point the finger to Coach Spurrier's defense this year is why they've, really struggled.
And unable to hold two touchdown leads any time of the game, even in the fourth quarter in the final minutes. You're right about Quarles and Cloudy. I think those are two things, two great players who could change how the opposing team's offense played. And certainly that's hurt them a lot. I do think Dylan Thompson's hurt him a few times, although he's had a great year statistically. But they got a great player in Pharaoh Cooper. I think you'll see him show up big on Saturday as well. On the other side, the Florida Gators, has Will Muschamp saved his job?
I think it's a little early, a little presumptuous to say that. I think he wins Saturday. There's going to be some certain things happen this year, namely if Georgia loses Saturday to Auburn. I think Missouri, they're a touchdown dog going into Texas A&M right now. They could very well lose that game and to Tennessee from what we've seen from Josh Dobbs. There's a scenario right now that's brewing, that's gaining some steam, that Will Muschamp is going to leave Florida to Atlanta if the pieces fall, and there's no way you can let him go after that. Furthermore, if he wins Saturday, beats Eastern Kentucky, obviously they're going to a bowl game, and then he plays Florida State competitively, or they have a chance to pull off the upset. Doe Campbell, wouldn't that be incredible? You know, there's no doubt in my mind that he's turned around. I think the complexion of the offense has changed with Treyon Harris. That was the biggest issue, has been the quarterback play over the last couple of years. And I think with an improved offense and you know, some momentum heading into the future and certainly for next year, I think Will is probably at the end of the day going to do enough to keep his job.
Question becomes, even if they didn't keep him, who are the desirable candidates? Mike Shanahan's name surface. We've seen different people's names surface. Quite frankly, I don't see a whole bunch of great candidates to take that job. Who are some names that you would throw out there?
Well, I think number one, you would start with a guy that I like right now that was a bad fail in Michigan, is Rich Rodriguez, and what he's done in Arizona. I think that's a really interesting name. I think they'll talk to guys like, you know, Coach Stoops, and the season that he's had in Oklahoma has been very frustrating for him. You know, maybe there's a potential there for kind of a new day for him. I don't see him, you know, going that direction. You know, I think while there are some candidates, I think at the end of the day, there's no Urban Meyer out there. There's no one guy you can look around the country and say, that's the guy that's going to lead us back to the promised land. So for that reason, I think Will is probably going to stay another year in Gainesville.
I agree with you, and our guest is the co-founder of Saturday Down South, a very fine website, which you should check out. Who are the coaches who have really done a terrific job? I noticed you mentioned Les Miles in your website, possibly him doing the best coaching job this year. Name me the two or three coaches who have done the best job this year of coaching in the SEC.
I think first and foremost, Les Miles is an interesting coach, and the record is not going to prove it this year, but this may be one of his best coaching jobs that he's done. He's got a very young team. You know, they have a huge liability in the passing game, very limited in that respect. But once again, I mean, he's got an elite defense, and they run the football, and there's a lot of talent to build around for the future, and a lot of these freshmen are starting to grow up right now, and a lot of them are banged up probably coming off Alabama, but I think Les Miles has done a great job this year. He's continually, in my mind right now, the most underrated coach in the SEC. He does a fabulous job, a lot of 10-win seasons there. Another coach that's interesting is Gary Pinkel at Missouri, and they haven't you know, come out and impressed anybody, but at the same time, the SEC East is theirs to lose for two straight years, and, you know, we're going down the backstretch. Last year they had to beat Texas A&M, you know, to win the East, and here we are. We're talking about teams of Texas A&M, Tennessee, and Arkansas. Those are three very winnable games for Gary Pinkel, and quietly he's had a great year, and obviously I would end with Dan Mullen and the job he's done at Mississippi State. You know, not a lot of big-name guys when they came in, but they've done a great job developing them.
Coach of the year would be Mullen?
I think at this point it'd have to be Dan Mullen.
Mm-hmm. Let's talk about the system. We've had a tremendous show for the last few Saturdays. We had three elimination games last Saturday. Certainly the quality of the games have been spectacular, particularly in the SEC. Now, let's look it down the road from this playoff system. What's going to happen? There's some scenarios for people saying, in the end, the SEC may be shut out. Others say Florida State doesn't deserve to be up there. If they played in the SEC West, they'd have at least two or three losses. Give me your evaluation, number one, on how this has worked out. And let's talk about teams like Florida State, whether they belong, even though they haven't lost a game. Some people say they're not as good as the teams in the SEC West because these teams in the West are playing tough games every Saturday.
Well, they really are. And let me say this about Florida State. I know this is Florida Gator country around here, but I think Florida State is the best team in the country. I think they have the best player in the country, and there's a lot of off-field issues with Jameis Winston, and he struggled a little bit in the passing game. I think the off-field issues are starting to show themselves a little bit on the field. He's thrown some picks the last few weeks. He's staring down some receivers, so there's some issues there with his on-the-field play as well, but I still think, you know, outside of maybe Marcus Mariota and Dak Prescott this year, I think Jameis Winston is probably the best quarterback in the country. Florida State is not elite. to me, there's not one elite team in the country. So for that reason, you can make a good argument for Florida State being the top two, even though they're undefeated. We can play the what-if game, whether they're in the SEC. We're going to find out. Florida may beat them and keep Jameis Winston out of the college football playoff. But, you know, I think at the end of the day, Florida State belongs in this discussion. And if they win out, they certainly are going to garner a spot in the top four and you know, make this college football playoff.
So I take that as a yes. You like this college playoff system.
I think as far as the playoff system is concerned, I think four is a happy median. I was kind of a BCS guy. I liked the way the system was, and for the most part, it did what it was designed to do. That's find the best two teams in college football. I think if we open it up past four, I think there's a situation there brewing that it could, you know, kind of ruin the best regular season in all of sports.
I agree with you on both counts. I see nothing wrong with what the BCS produced in the end. They got it right when it finally counted. All right, your final question. I don't know if you voted in the Heisman. I'm a Heisman voter, have been for years. Mariota's got to move to the top of the list of my list. I guess you'd have to put Jameis Winston and Dak Prescott. Anybody else you put on that list?
I think the best player at his position in the country has been Amari Cooper. And what he's done every week, and I mean, look, we've learned this. The quarterbacks win this award; other position players don't, and that includes running backs and even a player like Todd Gurley. And you know, he's pound for pound one of the best as well. I think Amari Cooper's probably the best player at his position in the country. I think Marcus Mariota has deserved enough right now to be the front runner, but Dak Prescott certainly can close strong with playing Alabama, Ole Miss, and the SEC championship.
All right, full disclosure here, the co-founder of Saturday Down South, John Cooper, is no kin to Amari Cooper. Just want to let folks know that. Listen, good job, good stuff. Appreciate it very much, John. Don't forget, Saturday Down South, it's a lot of good stuff.
Take care, guys.
Take care, thank you. Take a break, come back, wrap it up right here on Buddy Sports Page.
1370 AM, 96.3 FM, we're live and local on The Source.
Hi, this is Randy Briggs of the Briggs Law Firm. My son, Bo, and I practice exclusively in the representation of accident victims. And we've been asked many times why we would support and sponsor the program Ask the Cops with Sheriff Blair and Chief Graham, who are in the world of criminal law enforcement. Well, these legal rights actually overlap. In civil law enforcement, we're in the business of recovering for victims of accidents that which has been taken away from them and holding the responsible party accountable. Both civil law and criminal law share those common goals. So we're all in the field of law enforcement, and for that reason, we're proud to sponsor Ask the Cops on The Voice of Ocala with Buddy Martin. So if your family or a friend needs help in an accident situation, feel free to contact us at our website, www.thebriggslawfirm. We're located in the Ocala Historic District.
Nestled in the heart of horse country, just off I-75, exit 354, the award-winning and newly refreshed Howard Johnson Inn of Ocala invites you to pamper yourself in one of our comfy guest rooms. Enjoy our free and fast Wi-Fi, heated outdoor swimming pool, 24-hour fitness center, and our deluxe continental breakfast. Other on-site amenities include a restaurant, putt-putt, golf, and the car wash. Go happy, go Hojo at the Howard Johnson Inn of Ocala, proud sponsor of Friday Night High School Football on WOCA, The Source.
Hello, everybody. This is Terry Bradshaw, Fox NFL Sunday. Whenever I'm in Ocala, if I'm not singing and singing with my buddy Mel Tillis, then I'm listening to my longtime friend Buddy Martin on WOCA. Of course, I rarely get to Ocala, so if you believe that, I've got some horses I'd like to sell you. Some of them even have four legs. Regardless, I highly recommend you listen to Buddy Martin's Sports Page weekdays at 5 p.m. right here on The Source.
Hi, Danny Werfel here. Get moving with Florida Credit Union's fast and easy loan approval process.
Let Florida Credit Union start up a new car loan for you today. No more waiting, hassles, or stop signs. You can even apply online. With a strong financial team behind you, you can enjoy great rates and fast approvals.
It's all about personalized service and a streamlined process.
Florida Credit Union, connecting your money to your life.
On the next AM Ocala Live, Robin and I will be speaking to Dr. William Reed. He's one of the first successful heart surgeons in America, and he's written a book. It's called The Pulse of Hope.
News Bites, the hottest news and current events are bite-sized.
And then Dr. Gloria J. Walther is coming on. She's got a book called Eye to Eye, the handbook on lovingly and successfully parenting your 3 to 5-year-old child.
Lori Arnold is a multifaceted vocalist. She performed for Pope Benedict. She'll be on the air with John Leshak, and they'll be speaking about her concert on November the 16th.
And then representatives from the education community in Ocala and Marion County will be speaking about the salute to veterans.
Have all of your legal questions answered by attorney John Fuller on Legally Yours.
And then Paul Smith will be on. His book is called Parenting with a Story.
Sharon Nice is the president and CEO of the National Waste and Recycling Association. What becomes of the trash we throw away?
All of that plus fun with Joe on the next AM Ocala Live right here on the Source WOCA 96.3 FM.
1370 AM.
A garden, and we've got a show for you called You've Got a Garden with your host, Master Gardener Carol Ann Baldwin. Carol Ann answers your questions about your flowers, your veggies, your grass, your trees, even questions about your bugs. And she's only on WOCA, so don't miss Carol Ann Baldwin and You've Got a Garden each Tuesday from 9 a.m. to 10 a.m. right here on WOCA The Source.
WOCA.
Welcome back to Buddy Sports Page. Wrapping up hour three of the Sports Page on a Tuesday afternoon. By the way, one of our sponsors, Angie Lewis State Farm, ribbon cutting going on at her place right now, buddy.
Yeah, congratulations. I wish I could make it over, Angie, but I have other things you know about. And so
ribbon cutting, I'm going to try to stop by there. But, buddy, it's Veterans Day today. And, you know, Jeff Driscoll's got a lot of people on him and everything, but you got a pretty interesting letter from a veteran that it's a different take on Jeff Driscoll.
Yeah, well, first of all, as we said all day today, and as many others have, that we salute and honor our veterans, and we appreciate what they afford us to have a life with the way of life we have been protected over the years. And I just want to say that we have great respect and admiration for them, and we can't thank them enough. In fact, but one Veterans Day is probably enough. Not enough. We need to have probably a 365 for appreciating better. This is a letter that kind of sums it up, if I have time. This is a letter that was sent out today. It was written by Captain E.R. Gillickson from United States Navy, retired, to, of all people, Jeff Driscoll. Now, we know that Jeff Driscoll's gone through a tough situation. Starting the year, Tom, I thought he'd be the All-SEC quarterback. Turns out he even lost his job. The captain wrote. Dear Jeff, I want you to know that there are Gator fans who have been rooting for you throughout your career. We are still here. I know you have faced adversity and suspect it has been even more severe than most of us realize. Nevertheless, I've been impressed by the manner in which you have conducted yourself. I also know that you sacrificed a lot by turning from a promising and lucrative baseball career to follow your dream to become the quarterback of the Florida Gators. I admire your courage and appreciate your commitment to the school that I love. Several decades ago, my own tenure at Florida ended in a near disaster. I was fortunate enough to have another chance to realize my dream. Now, this old naval aviator knows that those who risk nothing will never understand those who live to put it on the line. You put it on the line. I don't know what your dream is at this point, but I wish you well. I hope that you find fulfillment and happiness. It is fashionable now to thank folks like me for our service. When it happens, I smile because that was not always the case. The public is fickle. I do know in all sincerity, thank you, though, for your service to the University of Florida. I would be UF-57 if I had lasted that long. On the other hand, my designation as a naval aviator occurred in 1957. Doors closed, doors open. When you see your door open, walk through it. Don't look back. I will close with a traditional farewell that is special, meaning those I admire most. Fair winds and following seas. Most sincerely and affectionately, Captain E.R. Gillickson, United States Navy, retired.
That's pretty good there. Pretty good. Puts it in perspective, doesn't it?
It does, yeah. And I'm sure that Jeff Driscoll, they say Jeff Driscoll just beamed about that letter. And, you know, sports can be a very good teaching tool. You know, and it teaches us things like, you know, it's cliche, but courage and, you know, and honor and what have you. And certainly, I think, even though he's gone through a tough year, Jeff Driscoll has done it with class. And I will always root for him. I'm sorry it happened to Jeff, but I'm glad he's handling it the way he is. And I think that speaks volume. I want to thank our guest today on the program, earlier today on the Food and Restaurant Show, Restaurant Food Show, Cindy Nicholson and Dave Del Rio. Of course, you heard from John Cooper, Saturday Down South. Earlier, David Cloninger from the South Carolina State. And on behalf of my broadcast partner, Tom Schmitz, and his assistant, Johnny Walker, I'm Buddy Martin. Have a great night, everybody.
Like a good neighbor, State Farm is there. And so is State Farm agent Angie Lewis, working hard to serve her community as a citizen and insurance agent. Angie wants to help you as you adjust your insurance needs.